Warning. The Drunken Peasants podcast is full of comedic exaggerations, independent thought, insensitivity, and other offensive content. We strongly urge all viewers and listeners to keep their brains and their skulls throughout the entire duration of this podcast. Failure to do so will result in immediate death. If you wish to support this podcast, there are several ways to do so. First, you can sign up for a free audiobook trial at audibletrial.com/drunkenpeasants. Audible is the foremost seller of audiobooks today, with hundreds of thousands of titles to satisfy all manner of tastes. Second, if you shop on Amazon.com, please use the Amazon affiliate links in the description section of this video. Every purchase you make helps to support this podcast's existence. Third, please peruse our merchandise and see if any of it strikes your fancy. We sell a lot of t-shirts, so we must be doing something right. One more thing before I go. To make an official submission to the Drunken Peasants, whether it be a video for one of our segments, or fan art, or a picture of you wearing one of our shirts, or anything you think we might want to use on the show, that stuff needs to be sent to the Drunken Peasants Facebook inbox. Please do not send correspondence, as this will be deleted unread. With all that shit out of the way, it's time to begin the show.
From the frigid armpit of America, this is the Drunken Peasants Podcast with Ben and TJ, bringing you opinions of the news from an altered perspective.
Fuck it!
Hey, man. You got a joint? No, not on me, man.
I don't have facts to back this up.
It'd be a lot cooler if you did.
What the fuck are you talking about, atheist?
It's okay.
You're nothing, okay. TJ. You're garbage.
Okay. I just want to be light.
You're garbage.
And now, here are your hosts, Ben and TJ.
We'll do it live.
We'll do it live. Fuck it. Do it live. Fucking thing sucks.
Hello, and welcome to the Drunken Peasants Podcast, episode 259. Yeah, and we're here.
259, oh so fine.
It is.
Be a lot better if it was 269.
69.
69 is a good number.
Yeah, and this is the second show we've actually done today, just to break kayfabe here
so
for a second.
So we're bored. We're bored with this already.
Yeah.
You guys are
so bored.
We're doing this so you motherfuckers...
You guys are getting a shitty leftover show.
Well, whatever. We're doing it so that they'll have shows to watch when we're out of town.
It's episode 259. What do you expect? You expect greatness from 259? Does that even sound like a good episode?
It will be an amazing fucking episode, TJ. We'll just
see.
Wait.
We'll see.
Just wait, because later...
No 238.
Well, later on in the show...
I personally am going to half-ass it.
Okay, well, that doesn't matter, because later on in the show, we're going to play an interview that Brett King conducted with someone who's going to accuse you of rape. So,
wow. Cool.
Rape.
Well, not on them, but they will make accusations that TJ left his high school because he raped somebody, which I don't get.
Sweet. Yeah, it was awesome. I remember that time.
That time you raped somebody and just left school?
Yeah. Well, what happened was I raped all the teachers in the school.
Wow.
And so they were afraid to teach me anymore.
So you basically raped your way through school.
I did. I kept getting rape promotions all throughout high school. I passed, even though I got straight F's and shit. I would
they'd
just rape the teacher, and they'd be like,
they'd
please,
like,
not him again, and they'd just promote me to the next grade.
Well, you are a cishet white male, so I mean...
Well, that's what we do. You know, I mean, it's rape culture. You know, it's Louisiana, so they're always 20 years behind, so it's even worse rape culture down there.
Wow. It's appalling.
You know, I rape. I mean, it's what I do.
Just a raper, dude.
It's not... There's nothing wrong with it.
You breathe, therefore you rape.
There's nothing wrong with raping people. It's fine.
God, I was telling you to pass it to Ben. You're so fucking dumb.
Ben don't want that shit.
You don't want this, Ben?
No, I'll tell you.
We need to teach TJ, dude. We need to teach TJ how not to rape, dude.
We do.
I already know how not to.
TJ, stop it. Stop trying to rape, TJ.
Stop raping.
TJ, come on.
No, fuck you.
Stop raping!
Stop it, TJ!
Why are you guys doing this to me? I feel like this is a violation.
This is an intervention, TJ. Paul
TJ,
came to me.
Oh. It makes the show look bad, TJ, when the manatee can find somebody that can scientifically corroborate rapes that you've committed, okay? It puts the power in his court.
That's coming up later in the show. Stay tuned for that. We're going to just talk about a few things really quick here.
Sorry.
The Drunken Peasants meetup in Toledo, Ohio is happening this coming Sunday.
152
Sunday, people. Sunday, Sunday.
152 people, all ages, July 17th, 9 p.m., Ottawa Tavern.
Oh, yeah.
And if you're one of those 183 interested, like, there's not room for all 183 of you. So yeah. Now's the time.
Good call.
Now's make the it time happen. to make that fucking decision. Switch it over to going. Come down, get drunk, have a good time. Well, maybe not drinking, but I don't know.
And potentially molest Paul.
That will happen, for sure.
Oh, wow.
That I promise.
Damn.
Yeah, we do live in rape culture, as we just established a moment ago.
If you don't live in that part of the country to come to the Toledo meetup, and you happen to live
in the South.
Yeah.
Drunken Peasants New Orleans meetup with Dusty Smith of Cult of Dusty, July 30th. It's going to be from 9 p.m. to midnight at the Napoleon House in New Orleans. And
gosh!
72 people going, 75 interested. We still got some room for some more motherfuckers to cram if been that son of a bitch. So if you're in New Orleans and you want to meet us... We'll be there.
We will all be there. We will all be at both of them.
This one is 21 plus, though, so...
Southern meetup.
This one is not all ages.
The South needs to rise.
A bunch of rednecks show up and make Ben uncomfortable.
Yeehaw!
You, Ben, I really like what you do on the show. Come on over here out back with me, and I'm going to show you my appreciation.
Yeah.
Fuck.
Come on, long hair. Let's go back to my truck. You got long, pretty hair. Yeah.
I like that a lot.
Oh, fuck.
You like a woman.
Soft like a woman. Yeah.
Nothing I like better than fucking me a northern boy in the asshole.
Northern boy booty.
Cornhole me a Yankee. Nah. Anyway, come to the New Orleans meetup.
Links down in the description. Please RSVP.
RSVP to either of these events if you're coming, please.
Yes.
That'd be great. So we know what to account for.
Yes. All right, time to move on.
Time to learn something.
All right. And this is a random page from the Drunken Peasants Wiki. I'm just pulling it up because I forgot to do that.
I'll just entertain the people in the meantime.
By humming clown music?
Yep. Just imagine the clowns are really scary.
Imagine they're stabbing TJ. Then knives find the way to his soft belly.
Oh, and by the way, later on in the show, we're going to be opening mail, and hopefully someone sent us that scary box of fake spiders that I've been asking for.
Oh, tails to the knob.
Hate Week, holy shit.
Hey.
This is a throwback.
Yeah.
This is the gift of Hate Week. I'm not going to try to do the Hate Week thing.
Hate Week.
Yeah, my throat is fucked, so I'm not bothering trying that shit. But Hate Week is an amply named. It should be aptly named. Get on fixing
amply.
That.
Amply.
Not amply.
It's amply.
Stupid fucking.
Amply. Retard.
Amply.
Fine. Amply named popular series of videos on The Amazing Atheist. The videos were generally on the shorter side with TJ tackling a single topic for a short period of emotional impotent rage. TJ hosted the first ever Hate Week in 2011. That's back when I was good.
Yeah.
Remember that? That's before I sucked.
Back when you still cared. Yeah.
Back when I still gave a shit.
When is there going to be another Hate Week, TJ? When's it going to happen?
Back when I still gave a fuck. Hate Week 2015. During his trip to Europe, TJ hosted a pre-recorded second Hate Week in a similar fashion to the original series later in 2015.
Doesn't count.
TJ commented he brought back the series by popular demand. He also stated the announcement of Hate Week 2, blah, 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 blah. People did not like Hate Week 2. The Hate Week in 2011 was filmed by the lesbian reptile fucktard Cody Weber. TJ jiggles his titties during day 5 of Hate Week 2011. You're welcome. Hate Week 2015 was a last-minute addition, according to TJ. Yeah, that was, like, the day before the trip, I'm like, oh, shit, let's make a whole fucking shitload of videos to make sure that we still make money while we're gone. And I did.
And the DP channel got shut down
while
we were gone.
Did it?
Yeah, by the Cristiano brothers.
Oh, those
the Hey Scotty shit.
Hey Scotty. Jesus, man. Da-na-na-na, Scotty sucks.
I've met crazy people that really believe that I orchestrated that. Like, you told them so they wouldn't play it anymore. I'm like, no, these guys are just notorious for doing this.
Yeah, Scotty was like, I'm going to financially shoot myself in the head by fucking my own podcast just so I don't have to deal with Hey Scotty anymore.
The Bible Reloaded guys had a online battle with the guy who runs the email address that flags all those fucking videos.
Yeah.
So, and I think they actually talked directly to one of the Cristiano brothers. It was a pretty interesting story.
The Cristiano brothers are a bunch of cunts.
They are.
Well, the guy that works for him is a total cunt, and he's out in, like, Indonesia or somewhere like that.
Indonesia.
Yeah, yeah, he's out in Indonesia.
Whoa. Fuck that guy.
Yep. All right, so we're going to watch an old video, a cringy old video of TJ's. There's going to be, like, blaring hypocrisy in this video. Just want to point that out.
Oh, great.
And this should be great. Let's watch it.
Okay, this video
How's
is
it hypocrisy?
Just a
Wait,
shit
hold
I
on.
Hate.
Give me a second here. Why is it hypocrisy?
Shit I hate.
Are you really going to do this shit like, back then you said this, but then later on in life you fucking learned different, so you're a hypocrite.
Blaring hypocrisy.
This is fucking 10 years ago. Shit changes. Fuck you. All right.
There's always an excuse.
White kids who think they're Muslims. You know, these little white kids in America.
I still hate that.
In Canada and shit, that think they're fucking Muslims. I had this friend, goes by the name of Yusuf.
You told this story just recently on the show.
Yeah.
I don't know what his real fucking name is. I'm sure Yusuf isn't his real name because he's not a fucking Muslim by birth. This kid, you talk about all the shit that goes on in the Islamic world. He says, well, that's just all the Islamic governments are fucked up, but it has nothing to do with Islam. You know, I'm like, it's not just the government to fuck up. Like, this whole thing with that bitch that named the teddy bear Muhammad or let her students name the teddy bear Muhammad.
Oh, yeah, I remember that. I remember that
shit. Wow, dude. That's going deep into the past, man. I remember all that shit. That controversy.
That fucking teacher named the teddy bear Muhammad, and then they're like, oh, sacrilege. And then they, like, wanted to, like, whip her or something or some shit. I don't know what ever happened with that. It's like one of those stories that everyone got all incensed about, and then, like, they never kind of reported a resolution.
That's
like,
true.
Eh. Everyone was pissed for 5 minutes, but now they're not anymore. Whatever.
Someone posted an article about it, and he said, well, that's just because that's a corrupt Islamic government in the Middle East, and none of those governments are any good, none of them really represent Islam. But you know what? It wasn't the government that was really pounding this bitch. It was the fucking people. The people came out in the streets and demanded she get a harsher punishment. They wanted her put to death, for fuck's sake. Thousands of people, huge crowds, signs, and burning her in effigy and all that bullshit. And he acts like that's not the real Islam. You know what, motherfucker? Maybe you're not the real Islam. You ever think about that? When the vast majority of people believe one way and you believe differently?
You know, it's funny because people are trying to talk like you're just now coming into, like, criticizing Islam.
Yeah, I know.
Like some other people inspired you to actually do it. You didn't do it on your own.
Yeah, like AIU being like, I'm glad I pulled you out of the regressive camp. It's like I was never in it. But whatever.
You can't claim that they're the pretenders and you're the true believer, motherfucker. It doesn't work that
motherfucker.
Way. Whoever, you know, it's like if you fucking...
Yeah, you're right, because, like, I mean, I've made tons of videos about Islam all throughout my channel's history.
And, oh, yeah.
And, like, every time, it seems almost every time I make a video about Islam, there's always at least one person who's like, finally the amazing atheist breaks his silence on Islam.
Yeah, jumps on the bandwagon.
It's like, shut up, you fucking cretinous swill.
Become a Christian, but you don't believe in Jesus. You believe in fucking aliens and shit, like the Seventh-day Adventists, and you say you're the true Christians, even though the vast-ass majority of Christians believe...
I even do the rocking back and forth thing when I'm standing.
Yeah.
Like, I'm literally, like, stepping back, stepping forward, stepping back, stepping forward. I've learned since then to, like, plant my feet on the ground a little bit better. I still move around a little bit, but...
Yeah, you know, and TJ expects to be able to rock as much as he wishes, but if you rock and sync with him, that is unacceptable.
That is true.
He wants to be the only one rocking, dude.
Yeah, fuck that. Fuck that. I'm going to rock as much as I want.
TJ is shaking and rocking right now.
Yeah. You don't fucking own rocking, bitch. You don't.
I'm TJ.
I own rolling, though.
Even some totally different shit than you. It's fucking ridiculous.
Dude, you called it 10 years ago like this. Nothing fucking changes about you, TJ.
I've always been a coughing ass motherfucker.
And you didn't even smoke weed then.
I didn't even smoke weed or cigarettes.
He did not.
I just coughed a lot. I'm just really, my throat is really easily irritated and congested very easily. No, I mean, like, it is. I mean, like, you know.
TJ's throat is easily penetrated.
I thought you were a doofus now, TJ. When I see this, like, damn. He's actually progressed somewhat. He's not as much of a dork as he used to be.
Whatever. I'm pretty much the same as I was here. I don't really feel like I'm that different.
Scott is a dork, dude. Don't even try to recover. Look at
him.
You want to see Scotty around this time, you know? Right. He was a little acne-pocked fucking little
acne-pocked
kid. Just like, hey, TJ, let's go.
Just trying to answer criticism with criticism, TJ. That's all you're saying.
You were exactly fucking Mr. fucking cool back then.
I was.
Fucking phlegm and snot in my fucking throat.
I don't know, man.
Phlegm and snot in your fucking throat, dude. You like literally, nothing about you has changed.
Hold on. Let's listen to some more.
And I gotta fucking swallow that shit because I don't like to spit. Spitting is just a repulsive thing.
Oh, why not?
It's more.
I've changed my stance on spitting since then.
Like, yeah, like, why would you want to swallow all that fucking phlegm? That's just gross.
Fucking just swallowing the phlegm and snot and feeling it all go down my throat. Ugh! That's fucking nasty. Who the fuck likes that shit? Nobody.
Okay.
I hate is fucking 12-step programs, especially Alcoholics Anonymous. The first step is to admit you're fucking powerless. And you gotta, only God can fucking help you quit alcohol. No, motherfucker, the first step is...
I remember these garage days, man.
This kind of feels more like stand-up.
Days.
You know, when you're doing this, it feels more like you're doing like a stand-up routine, whereas like your videos now, you just feel like you're making a video.
I think it's weird that we randomed Hate Week on the information segment, and then now we're playing a video by TJ talking about a bunch of shitty hates.
I'm just a hateful man.
This is like proto-Hate Week here.
Goddamn responsibility. You know, I'm sick of all these fucking faggots bitching about it. Addiction. Wow. I'm addicted. I can't stop smoking.
Yeah, there it is.
I'm addicted to heroin. People have...
Oh, damn.
All right, so now he's going to elaborate on this.
Fucking quit smoking in the past. People will continue to quit smoking in the future. It's not impossible. You're just fucking weak. Okay? You know...
You're just fucking weak, TJ.
Well,
dude,
I am, I guess.
From yourself, from the past, dude.
You past, TJ. God, you don't understand what you're talking about.
You were addicted to smoke, and then you could be all smug about it. Like, I don't smoke. I don't need to smoke. Now you're a total fucking addict. You're sitting there, oh, man, well, yeah, I guess I am weak.
It's like, I don't fucking sit around saying, oh, I'm physically addicted to food. I can't possibly give up. It's a compulsion. No, I like eating fucking food.
I like smoking cigarettes.
And you know, sometimes
fuck
I
you.
Watch what I eat, other times I don't give a shit. But you know what?
Fuck you, TJ. You're a cuck. Why don't you go back?
I actually do think you have
about Islam.
I think you do have compulsions to eat food, TJ. I mean, especially back then.
Yeah. Well, I mean, we had a diet weight loss contest.
Yep.
And TJ couldn't even go 2 weeks.
No.
He went like a week and like a couple days.
Fuck that.
Yeah, you do have a compulsion then. Yeah, you're just totally wrong, TJ.
Wow. I don't sit there and fucking try to sell you some bullshit like it's an addiction, like I can't help it. I'm powerless against it.
Yeah,
you whiny fucking cunts.
You know what TJ just said earlier? He said, well, I'm just stupid when it comes to that.
I am.
I know, that's what I'm saying. So, like, now it's like, TJ, you're totally proven the case against you.
It was a flaw. I mean, like, it's a flaw in my character, and back then I didn't know that it was a flaw in my character, so whatever.
Well, not even just in specifically smoking. It's basically you're making fun of, like, addiction. Like, oh, I don't see why anyone would just keep doing something even if they know it's detrimental. But, I mean, look, you do. So now I think you kind of understand better why you were wrong.
Uh-huh.
So do you admit you were wrong about this?
No, that TJ from 10 years ago was wrong.
Yeah, so at that time that occurred, you were wrong.
No, I was probably right at the time.
But, no, oh, see, you can't admit you're fucking wrong, TJ. You can't just for once admit you were wrong
the
about
world,
something.
The world has changed since then.
You can say, you can say, yeah, you can say now you've changed on it, TJ, but then you were not. You were wrong.
I mean, it doesn't necessarily
at that point in time, you were fucking wrong.
The facts themselves might have changed.
You were fucking wrong, TJ. Just say it. I was wrong.
I was right then.
You
I'm
were
right
wrong.
Now.
You're always fucking wrong,
and if the
TJ.
Two things are contradictory.
That's what's so funny about you is because we always know you're fucking wrong, and you still like, no, I'm right, dude. And no one else is convinced, so what's the fucking point?
What do I give a shit if someone else is convinced?
Oh, you do. Oh, you think if you said something to Paul and he kind of smirked, you would just be like, oh, I don't care what Paul thinks.
I don't.
Oh, no, you care a lot what Paul thinks.
Fuck
that's
Paul.
Bullshit. Oh,
Paul.
See, that's proof right there.
Fuck you, too.
Oh, you might say you can ignore what I say, but there's no way if Paul was like, I don't know, TJ would be all like, what Paul thinks about me?
Yeah, yep.
Yep.
I don't know how Ben deals with these fighting boys all the time. Poor Ben and these boys.
It's not fighting. It's
fighting.
Just Scotty berating me like some fucking angry housewife.
I'm not berating you, TJ. I'm just speaking the truth, man. If you don't like the truth, TJ, just stop listening.
I wish I could.
I wish you could, too. You know, TJ, even more, I wish you could acknowledge that you're wrong.
Mm.
You know, TJ, why can't you ever acknowledge? You obviously
let's
been
talk
wrong
about TJ's two favorite bands ever and how TJ found out about both of them.
Mm-hmm.
Let's talk about that.
That's a good idea. So, TJ, where did you first hear Manson?
REO, Speedwagon, and Fleetwood Mac.
What was
my favorite bands?
Who was it that got a Manson album for Christmas and then you listen to the album and suddenly you liked it?
What does this prove? You liked something before I did.
My influence was clear, though, is what I'm saying.
Yeah, your influence, whatever.
And what's that band you really love? What's that band, Ben?
Ghost.
Oh, Ghost.
Also known as Ghost BC.
Mm-hmm.
Hmm. How'd you hear about them, TJ? What was it that...
Ben.
Oh.
Yeah. So what?
So that means... That means we're responsible for you liking those bands,
we
right?
We are. No, those bands being something I like is responsible.
No,
you're responsible.
You never would have heard them if it wasn't
You're responsible for maybe subjecting me to them, but that's about it.
That's subjected you to your modern morality.
Yeah.
There's plenty of things that
How
you
much
guys,
were you influenced by Marilyn Manson?
There's plenty of things that both of you guys
how many
have shown
times,
me that I thought sucked and didn't
How many times
care
has Manson influenced you in your life, TJ? I am a huge influence on you.
Uh-huh.
And that's just proven. I mean, you're going like, I was attracted to that, TJ. Then you became deeply attracted to Manson, his message, his music, his personality, his persona.
Yeah, right.
And I was the catalyst
for this
event.
Yeah, all right. I guess everything
If there was no Scotty, there would be no TJ, really.
Oh, yeah. The TJ who's always wrong. So thanks to you, the fucking pitiful garbage piece of shit that exists.
You know what, TJ?
Exists.
I'm not responsible for what happens. You've chosen this path, TJ.
Oh, now I'm in control.
But I started it, TJ. The chain of events that occurred was I is the one that started
it. So I can sue you for all my problems in life, then.
Well, those problems
Scotty,
are your own doing.
I demand reparations since you have set in motion the chain of events that has caused me to be this pathetic wretch that I am.
All right, we're going to move on.
Okay.
Please do.
Yeah. Fuck yeah.
DP Action News.
Yes, it's so epic.
We have choppers. Get to the chopper!
All right, here's D.L. Hughley on CNN responding to something Rudy Giuliani said, which I believe was probably...
Wow, I already know.
Okay. All right. So here it is.
No one can give me that kind
of... There is a danger in false parody.
Sure.
You're right. There's statistics going around now that, hey, did you know that more whites get shot by cops than blacks?
You know why?
You don't adjust for population, and there are a lot of other factors that go into it as well. In fact, I had one guy, I've been researching this like crazy, because I'm trying to understand how I can be a value here. It can't...
Can you please let the person of color speak, sir? You bring him on your platform just so you can make your little white speech.
Oh, he's supposed to be validated by having a black man in his presence, TJ.
Disgusting.
Say this way. And I had a social scientist say
racism,
to me,
racism.
You know, this idea that blacks resist more than whites.
Right.
He's like, you know, I put my hand on it. I don't think that's even true because blacks have such an odd disposition when it comes to police. They feel that they have to acquiesce in a way a lot of whites don't. They feel they can have conversations and pressure.
Yes, more white people get shot by police than black people. About 120 more.
Right.
But there are 120 million more white people.
That's right.
If you adjusted it for
sure.
percentage, what's
not even close.
We are five times more likely to be shot.
Five times more likely.
You know what happens? That racism.
Yeah, but once again, you're also, like, you're about five times more likely to commit most fucking violent property crimes, too. So,
racism and bigotry have great PR. They have great PR. People throw out statistics like that that they know aren't true, but people will believe it because they want to. The fact is that...
You never made an argument the statistic isn't true. You just made an argument that didn't provide the full context. But you guys aren't providing the full context either. My problem here.
Well, I don't think anyone's really going to give you the full context.
I mean, obviously, no one can
give you their narrative.
But I mean, there's just a very obvious thing that they're just ignoring.
Well, it has to be. I mean, obviously, to be devil's advocate, those things have to be addressed in some way. And obviously, they're just going to say, "Oh, well, statistics are bullshit if they don't line up with what we want them to."
Mm-hmm.
That's what both sides do.
Of course, that's my big grievance in this fucking entire discussion is that I see both sides telling half the story, and neither one of them is willing to go across the aisle and be like, okay, well, let's look at the whole story together and figure out the real fucking shit that's going on.
But furthermore, it's like if you take two halves of the story and it doesn't really add up to like what seems like reasonably to be the truth as well. You know what I mean? Like, it's not like you hear both sides and you say, well, maybe the truth is this one or this one. It's like obviously the truth is probably not in either of those narratives.
I'm not saying the truth is in like just automatically somewhere in the middle or something.
No, of course not.
But I'm saying that, you know, if you just go around with confirmation bias and say, well, I'm going to pay attention to this statistic, but I'm going to ignore this one, or I'm going to only pay attention to that statistic and ignore those other two that they're bringing up. I mean, like, you're not looking at the full picture. You're intentionally keeping yourself ignorant of certain aspects of the problem and then expecting to form a cogent solution based on that. It's
not
gibberish.
Only that, but you're stopping any conversation that might come from looking at both sides. Like when you throw out black crime statistics and immediately are shouted down as a racist, that removes a huge chunk of data that is needed to come to some sort of a solution. So you're never gonna solve things by ignoring one half of things and just looking at the half that supports your narrative.
Yeah, and then there's other factors as well. I mean, there's probably a lot of variables that could be brought into this discussion that just aren't admitted, that are beside from that, you know?
Black people are five times more likely to be shot than white people. Black-on-black crime, more white people commit crime than black people. It is true, even if you adjust it for population.
No, that is not true. Where are you getting that? I've looked at the FBI statistics. I've looked at the Department of Justice statistics. I mean, I've not seen any statistics that back that up.
This is really the problem, is it just gets into rhetoric, because I agree with you. I think even if that was true, I don't think he's citing it from some point of knowledge. I think that's his personal belief he's citing as, you know, almost as a fact.
But, I mean, he's sitting there saying that even adjusted for population, white people commit more crimes than black people. That's just, it's not true. It's fucking just simply not true. I don't know what study he could possibly cite as that.
Well, I think the argument for that comes from more of them saying, well, white people commit just as many crimes, or if not more, they just don't get caught. It's basically the police presence in their community is basically specifically targeting them and finding something they're doing wrong.
Well, I mean, there could be police. The police probably are targeting them in some instances. I mean, you know, that's fine. That could be part of the fucking discussion as well. But it doesn't change the fact that, you know, there's fucking high criminality in their fucking neighborhoods and shit.
Well, what would you say is the reason?
What I say is the reason for that?
Yeah.
I mean, I think poverty is part of the answer. I think that just cultural fucking mindsets are part of the answer. You know, I mean, obviously, if you look at all of fucking human history, it's not like the white race has been this shining beacon of fucking peace or some shit.
No, definitely not.
We've been violent, bloodthirsty, horrendous fucking monsters. Just as all human beings are capable of being. So I think that, you know, it's I don't know the fucking exact reasons, but I think it should be something that should be honestly discussed and investigated, not just saying like, well, it's just a race thing or it's this or it's that. I don't understand. I mean, anybody who has like, who's like, I have a simple, easy to understand solution to this problem is full of shit. It's like the H.L. fucking Mencken quote. I'm going to paraphrase it, but it's for every problem, there is a solution that is simple and elegant and wrong.
More white people commit crime than black people. But when you say black on black crime, that gives you the incentive to go out there and do something about it. It gives you a call to action. Now we have an immediate situation that has to be dealt with. And when we repeat those things, it gives it breath.
What? Sorry, that was...
It gives it breath.
That was actually gibberish that you just speak. maybe don't have fucking cut-rate comedians comment on important social issues. I mean, I'm just saying.
Zibbity-zobbity-bibbity-bobbity.
And again, look where we are.
We had a police shooting. Who do we call? Let's get D.L. Hewley.
You know, I'm not exactly the most fashionable person on earth, but yeah. This dude's fucking fashion is horrid.
Yeah, this is something that like a pimp looks at.
Yeah.
And goes like, too much.
Too much.
Tone it down.
Too flashy.
Tone it down.
Yeah, what the fuck?
Yeah, he looks absurd, but that's fine, whatever. He can dress how he wants. I don't give a shit.
Sure.
But
you also have
ridiculous.
A situation where what happens in the immediate sense?
His hat looks like something like a little English schoolgirl would wear or something.
Often context gets
except for the feather, minus the feather.
Why do you have more blacks coming into contact with police where it turns violent? So you start looking at the numbers. Well, where are these police? Well, what's going on in those neighborhoods? Now, you can stop your analysis right there and say, they're high crime, poor black areas. Feel for the police. They have to do the job. But why are they high crime areas? Where is the education? Right. Where is the opportunity? This is complex. And I often feel that the
This is complex. Yes, you're right. It is.
Yeah,
yeah, that's true.
It's an extremely complex
issue.
Isn't
that people don't have an open mind? Is we don't want to go there. We don't want to go to the real reasons. Let's just end it with this one guy and this one cop and leave the analysis. But do you think that's the right way to do it?
Obviously, it hasn't served them well. Like, if you look at Tamir Rice was a 13-year-old kid playing with a toy gun, right?
Yeah.
The police officer that shot him was employed by the Independence Police Department and fired because he was out of the academy. He was such a bad police officer, they thought that no amount of training would ever make him a reasonable officer.
Mm-hmm.
Then they put that very officer 9 months later in Cleveland, and he killed someone. And society, and we all know this happened, and he's let off, and it's not his fault? You cannot tell me all lives matter when some are treated distinctly different. I can mourn for police officers that are slain.
I mean, they still matter. Just because people are treated differently doesn't mean you can't say that their lives matter.
I mean, look, Tamir Rice, tragic fucking case. I think that the cops acted inappropriately as fuck.
In that case, yeah.
I mean, they drove right up on the kid, got out of the car, and shot. Like, that's ridiculous. No reasonable person thinks that's the way to handle a situation, especially with a 13-year-old with a toy gun. I mean, of course, you know, maybe they thought it was a real gun, but you don't fucking just drive right up on them, jump out, boom, boom, boom.
Man, these guys just think they're fucking cowboys, dude. We just gonna go in there, that kid's got a gun, he got a fucking machine gun, we just gotta pop out and shoot him.
120, I mean, we saw a video earlier today when we were doing the pre-recorded show of a fucking black guy who was naked and tearing down a fence and the cops weren't shooting him. You know, the cops deal tons of people every day. You know how many black people they've shot? This year, 123. It's high. It's too high. Shouldn't be that many people getting shot in general. But is that really astronomical? Is that the biggest threat to the black community?
No.
I mean, I would say that compare the number of black people shot by police to the number of black people shot by other black people in their own neighborhoods, and one figure is astronomically higher.
I mean, there's so many things you could look at. If you looked at the poverty rate, it's like the people are going hungry. I mean, there's so many, disease. There's so many different things that are going to have a much greater impact on that community more than likely than that. I mean, obviously, it's a very divisive issue. But at the same time, there's a lot of other important things going on there, too. I think they're just kind of being brushed aside in favor of focusing almost exclusively on people being killed.
Yeah, I mean, like, the problem is definitely wider than just people getting shot.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, that's what I'm saying. Like, it's happening for a reason. There's got to be some reason this is occurring. You know what I'm saying?
Well, of course, there's always a reason. I mean, whether or not human beings can actually figure it out is another fucking matter.
And I can mourn for two young black men that were slain. There's no, I don't have a moral dilemma in it.
I think that all lives matter. Is a perversion of what makes Black Lives Matter special.
Sure.
Maybe Black Lives Matter was started with people who had good intentions, but now it's become out of control. It's a movement that's antithetical to what it should or what it claims to stand for.
I mean, there's like getting their heads smashed with bricks. There's people screaming, kill all white people. There's people screaming, kill all white babies.
Okay, well, you have to remember.
I mean, there's people chanting, like, what do we want? Dead cops. When do we want them now?
Yeah, and even, I mean, and that's, like, the worst of it. But even, like, the shit, like, blocking traffic and stuff.
What about the Toronto Pride Parade?
I mean, that's annoying.
That was hijacked by Black Lives Matter.
But I mean, isn't it cliche, but isn't it true, like, the road to hell is paved with good intentions? Because people always start off with the best of intentions.
Yeah.
Like, we want to fight this injustice, but then it always morphs into something more. And I mean, I'm not even saying the people that have committed the crimes, like the killing the police, were directly tied to Black Lives Matter. I don't know. But at the same time, was this kind of rhetoric affect people? Of course it does.
Yes.
Well, Black Lives Matter is such a nebulous organization. There's not really a rigid hierarchical structure to it. So the bad thing about that is that, you know, there's a number of crazy people running around out there.
But for
saying,
people that deny,
Black Lives
but
Matter,
for people
fuck
to deny
whitey, you know?
The correlation between rhetoric and the things people say and the actions and how riled up people get and saying this, it's still in the case of Black Lives Matter, anything bad that happens is totally devoid from this. There's no correlation or connection of any kind. It's ridiculous. It's not true.
Black Lives Matter gives people something that a lot of people in this country and in the Western world at large are looking for, which is an excuse for their own problems. That's why Black Lives Matter has gone out of control, because it gives people that reassurance that they're not responsible for anything that goes wrong in their lives, and that doing things like walking into a fucking public college library and screaming Black Lives Matter at the top of your fucking lungs is fighting an imaginary enemy. They want some kind of cause to rally behind that is to blame for their fucking problems, but there is none. And so it's just anger and resentment for the sake of it. That's the problem.
There's an obvious inequity. Everybody knows that. The reasons for it need to be debated. Sure. How you fix it needs to be prayed for. Sure. But there's an
prayed for? I don't think that's going to do it. Sorry.
Yeah, obvious parody. My question
do
to
it.
You
pray
is, I want to leave
it.
With us on this. One, I want your promise to continue this conversation. Two, I want you to give me your best sense of how can we get better from where we are.
It is a simple, you know, everybody asks that question. Do unto others as you would have them do unto you. I watched the movie A Time to Kill, and at the end of it, he made this great analysis, and he said if she were white, he made the equivalent to her being white. People are treated differently. Biases, police officers have fears and biases. That there's no doubt about that. And they're based on any number of things. But if your fears and biases get me killed, and my anger and frustration get you killed, we're going to act human. We are no less or more human. Every time you turn around, somebody is making a moral reason why somebody's slain in the streets. And if it's an abhorrent behavior. And it would be abhorrent if I see a young black man slaughter five police officers, or whether you see police officers slay like. When Rudy Giuliani says that Black Lives Matter are terrorists, Black Lives Matter, let me tell you something.
I don't think they're terrorists, but I do think that they can be nuisances in some respects.
I mean, I think they use intimidation tactics a lot of the time. I don't think that makes them terrorists.
No.
I don't think that they're out there saying, let's bomb, you know, white buildings or whatever.
Yeah, well, if they start doing something like that, that's a different story. But right now, I wouldn't say they're a terrorist group.
Yeah, so, I mean, whatever. I wouldn't call them terrorists. But, I mean, they definitely use bully tactics, intimidation tactics.
How about the one guy the one guy that did the shooting, though?
I would say that's a terrorist act. But
I would have to say.
If there was some evidence that, like, the organization of Black Lives Matter had some sort of thing to do with, like, the funding of that the planning of it or something.
Then they would be a terrorist organization.
Yeah, but, you know, just because it's some guy fucking adopts some anti-white rhetoric, it doesn't necessarily mean that it's Black Lives Matter that's doing it. I mean, just like everyone who fucking...
Yeah, he's an ideologue. We can't necessarily say, like, he had sympathies for that, but we can't say, like, he went to the leaders of his local Black Lives Matter chapter or whatever and was like, you know, give me weapons, give me training, I'm going to kill white cops. And they're like, okay, I'll do it. There's no evidence to suggest that at this point.
Wow, look at this screenshot.
He just opening his mouth with a big white dick. What to come in there?
What to come in there?
The white man is here.
I saw...
fucked by the white man again.
I saw Pimp Monk in the chat. Pimp Monk is going to come to the New Orleans meetup, presumably to make out with a man.
Huh.
Neat.
And then claim that he's straight and come up with some sort of excuse
for
why. Pitmonk's
just going to be at the New Orleans meetup to eat.
Dude, Pitmonk, after that one episode where we said that it would be $50,000 to fuck his ass, he actually wrote me, he's like, my ass is worth more than $50,000.
50.
I'm like, your ass ain't worth 50 cents, dude. Yeah, dude.
$50,001. How about that?
Most people would pay $50,000 to keep your ass away from their cock.
That was just my side of the fucking, you know, of the deal. Like, it would take me $50,000 to put my dick in Pitmonk's ass.
That's what I'm saying.
He might, hey, whatever, dude. The value of his ass is not for me to determine, you know.
It's not $50,000.
No.
A lot of people would pay $50,000 to keep my dick out of their ass, too. So, you know what I mean?
Oh my God, TJ, this is going to freak you out. I'm going to show this to you because you're going to be like, no, why is this going to exist? But here's an intro for a new show.
A new show?
Yeah, a new show that's coming to YouTube, and this intro was made by Ronnie Lump. Here it is.
Oh, God.
No.
The Egghead Show.
No. No. I don't think the internet's ready. We're not ready, dude.
How long is this? 23 seconds? Well, that ensures no one will watch this.
Just long enough for me to fucking get bored and find something else to watch.
I like how you just hear his voice like, the Egghead Show.
The Cringe Corner with your host, Egghead.
Man, people have seriously, like, in the New Orleans meetup discussion written things like, just someone pick Egghead up and leave him in the middle of nowhere. Don't let him come. Like, there's people that really don't want him to come to the meetup. I really believe that.
Oh, whatever. He can come. That's fine.
Yeah, man, fuck that. Whatever.
No, we're not saying he can't come. I'm just saying, like, it's just funny that people don't want him there. Like,
can you hand me that?
Genuinely.
When I offered Egghead a ride, I was planning on getting about halfway to New Orleans and getting on, like, stopping at a gas station and going, Egghead, go in there and get me a soda, man, and just leaving.
Paul would come back, not for Egghead. He'd just be like, man, that soda actually does sound pretty good. Yeah.
Toss it in.
Let the soda in first. I'll let you in after.
Toss it through the window. All right. We have to bring this patron onto the show, but it's not Egghead, so don't worry.
Oh, thank God.
It's not Egghead.
Oh, God, it's not Egghead. Not Egghead? Not Egghead.
Egghead.
Hello.
Why, hello there.
How's it going?
Oh, you know. You know how it is, just, you know, doing a wildly popular internet podcast.
Cool.
As long as you're not Egghead, it all good.
No, Egghead definitely bummed me out just now. But you know, what are you gonna do?
Man, I'll tell you what, I'll watch at least one episode of the Egghead Show. I'm gonna give you a chance to set your hooks in me, Egghead. I'm gonna give it a shot.
I think
Let's see what
like,
you got.
I think the best part of the Egghead Show will be the comment section. If he doesn't censor the comments, it's going to be fucking priceless.
Yeah, dude.
We may even do a segment where we read the comments on the show. Hey, everybody wins. Egghead gets views because like people will go and comment on the video.
Yeah.
Because they want us to read their like ridiculous comments ragging on Egghead.
That's awesome.
Yeah, there you go.
It should happen.
Mutually beneficial for all.
I guess the Egghead Show should exist then.
Before we get on to the next segment where TJ is going to address allegations made against him, I want to remind everyone that we do have a DP Clips channel. It's called The Best of DP. There's a link in the description. And the reason it's called Best of DP is because it is clips that a lot of our fans have told us are the best segments that we've ever done in the history of the show. So if you're relatively new to the show, you haven't seen older episodes, you'll be able to see some of the best clips from those older episodes. So you don't have to go back and scroll through them.
It's also worth noting that if ever we have trouble on this channel again, that will be the backup channel that we broadcast.
Yeah, so you might as well subscribe already.
Yep.
You know?
Just in case we get hit by that Brett Keane damn shit.
Oh, yeah, right, dude.
Speaking of which, I think it's time.
The time has come.
Check out that beautiful asshole.
The individual protein segment situation.
Yeah. Rock
on. I love that he's got a big turkey. That's the best.
So this is a 4.5 minute clip from a recent Brett Keane hangout. And someone joins the call and tells an interesting story regarding TJ.
Oh, wow.
Here it is.
You don't have a webcam?
All right, Dean, do I know you or somebody else?
Yes, I'm Dean Bryan. I'm from Louisiana.
All right, well, how do I know?
All right, I'm going to say immediately, no, you're not.
I'm from Louisiana. He's from Louisiana, dude.
Born and raised in Louisiana.
He sounds just like anyone I've
ever met. That's like how I would say it.
Yeah,
Louisiana.
You said that northern as well, dude.
There's really, you do not sound like you're from Louisiana.
You don't sound like you're from my part of Louisiana anyway.
No, he does not sound it, but let's hear. Maybe we'll hear more of it.
Maybe he's dropped the accent in the intervening time.
That's what I'm saying. Maybe so.
Oh, you.
I just found out about your channel the other day.
Okay. All right. Well, Dean, we'll give you an opportunity. I'll just have to set it to where if you do something weird, people won't be able to see it and hear it. Just for a while until I get to know you. You understand? I got a lot of trolls, assholes.
This sounds like a Brett Keane plant, dude.
Oh, yeah. Because
at first he wasn't even doing a southern accent, and now he is doing one. He's like, I'm from Louisiana. Yeah, man.
Now all of a sudden he's Boomhauer or something.
I can totally understand. I can understand your proxy.
It's all good. So okay, Dean, Brother Brown helps away from the computer, tell me a little bit about yourself. You're from Louisiana. What's it like down there?
Actually, Brett sounds more like he's from Louisiana.
Thing is, I went to high school with T.J. Kirk, whatever.
You did? How'd that work out for you?
It was pretty disgusting.
It was pretty disgusting.
You say he went to high school with me, huh?
Okay.
Yeah, this sounds like fucking fake-ass shit.
It sounds so fake already.
I mean, like,
he's not mentioning any of the high schools or anything.
Here's
either.
The problem with this already. Like, no one I went to high school with ever fucking would have even known me as anything other than the tall, quiet guy.
Oh, just wait until how he describes you. It's fucking ridiculous.
Person I ever knew.
You actually went to high school with him in Louisiana, and he was the worst person you've ever known.
Listen to this leading.
Dude, that's so ridiculous.
Listen to this fucking leading.
Okay, she did not really communicate with anyone. There's no fucking way that she would have been the worst fucking person.
I was the most asocial person. And, I mean, like, Brett is like coaching this guy through this fucking story. I mean, this is bullshit.
Oh, it's transparent, dude. It's transparently somebody that Brett Keane is affiliated with that he got to make this fucking call in and make these spurious claims so he would have something to use against you. It's so transparent, dude.
I want to hear the rest, though. This is great.
This is probably the same fucker that made that message from me.
Oh, yeah.
People in high school, he was the worst.
Yeah, he would always come in, be rude to the teachers. He would always be rude, spat on one of the teacher's faces one time. It was pretty gross.
Dude, you are so full of shit. Because you know what? There's no way in Louisiana TJ would not have gotten in trouble for that, and I would have fucking heard about it. There's no fucking way.
Did they have corporal punishment in your school?
Yes.
Yeah, so TJ would have got his ass whacked for doing something. Probably would have got the cops called on him, too.
Oh, yeah. There's no fucking way that would
have. At the very least, I would have been suspended for like 15 days for that.
There's no fucking way. This dude, he's officially entered bullshit territory. He did not go to school with TJ.
Wow. Goodness gracious.
Wow.
That's a
great... Brett, you're not even fucking surprised. You're such a fucking bad fucking liar, dude. Wow, TJ. TJ committed... whatever the guy, his name is. TJ committed a crime, and he did a lot of bad stuff. I'm shocked.
Wow. Read the line next bullet
I fed
point.
You. The lines I fed you, you're delivering them just like we planned. Wow.
Read that next bullet point that I sent to you. Wow. So TJ spat in a teacher's face. Wow.
It was right around the time my dad knocked out my teeth.
Wow. Yeah.
Sorry so about you, this, but,
Were you in the same class with him, or he was just you seen him from time to time?
We had like one class with each other, but. Denny.
Each other? That is Louisiana.
Yeah.
Thick southern accent.
Oh, God. That's such bullshit.
We went to school with each other. That's not how people from Louisiana talk.
Grade A bullshit.
kind of then he dropped out. But there is a rumor that he dropped out because he raped somebody.
Damn, really?
Yeah, apparently he raped someone at the high school, but I don't know who it is, but...
I have no evidence, but apparently that happened. Dude, you didn't go to school with TJ. You don't even know the name of the fucking high school. What class was it even? What teacher was it? You know, like, there's all records of this stuff, so if you did all that, then we could verify what you're saying.
So here's what we're supposed to believe. Somebody called up Brett Keene's hangout on the whim, just discovered Brett Keene within the last couple of days. I just found out about you. You heard him at the beginning. And just happens to want to feed Brett Keene a bunch of negative information about you. Brett, this is so fucking transparently concocted by you that it's sad that it even exists. It's super fucking sad that this exists.
I mean, they're right about me being a rapist, though. I mean, I have raped.
Okay, literally, if it was anyone but Brett Keene, I would say it was beneath them. But Brett, there's just no low for Brett. So it's nothing could be beneath Brett.
No, there's no bottom floor.
People are saying that this is slander.
I would say yes.
Unfortunately, no evidence.
But of course, it's not Brett saying it.
It's not Brett.
It's Proxy saying
that's
it.
That's why it's not Brett Keene saying this shit. That's why it's little fucking...
Anonymous Proxy. Yeah.
Dean Bryan, you know, random guy who called in my show, said this stuff, and then never appeared again.
Yep.
It's like, whatever.
Rape somebody he was accused of it, and then he disappeared.
My goodness. You're saying that the Amazing Atheist was at your high school, in your area, and he actually dropped out of high school
what area is
accusations
that even?
Of rape. These are your words. I didn't say this.
Oh, how transparent is that?
Like, done.
There it is.
It's done.
There it is, dude. Like, it's you don't even have to fucking comment on it, Brett. It's so fucking... I want to imply that the Amazing Atheist is a rapist, but I don't want to subject myself to legal problems, so let me get one of my crazy cronies to crawl in and pretend he went to high school with Oh my God, Brett. Just stop,
I'm not saying
dude.
It! Dude, it's the Brett. Come
I just
want to
make it clear I'm not the one saying
dude, there's nothing beneath Brett. There's nothing.
And, like, if you know, people are out there like, well, you guys criticize Brett all the time. We criticize things that he openly does, like this. Like having a shill come on and pretend that he went to fucking high school with TJ. No follow-ups to corroborate that evidence, by the way. No, like, which high school? What year did you graduate? Blah, 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 blah. What were some of the classes and the names of the teachers at the high school? No, just like, oh, just out of the blue, I'm on a hangout, somebody joins and has this hot info on TJ. And it's not me saying it, these are your words.
That's pretty rough. I assumed today whenever I opened this room up, we were going to talk about things like Pokemon and Skyrim. I had no idea.
You didn't. What, Brett? Bullshit. You assumed? Yeah. You assumed that chat was going to be anything, but TJ is the fucking piece
of shit.
You
might as well just be like whistling like...
Yeah.
Old innocent Brett.
I was just sitting here minding my business.
Dude, he lays it on so fucking thick, and it's like, I thought today we'd be talking about Pokemon Go, and someone just happens to bring up the Amazing Atheist, who am I hate.
You know, every other day I spend the entire hangout situation talking about the Amazing Atheist, but today, I was thinking we'd be talking about Pokemans.
But then this new information comes to light.
Brett, Brett Keene is a fucking movie character. He's like he's basically like a movie antagonist. How ridiculous he is! Like his schemes that never bear any fruit, that are so transparent that a fucking blind person could see them. I mean, come on, Brett. We saw right through this. Like within like 2 seconds, like this is bullshit.
Yep.
Listen,
it's sad how you guys will defend a rapist like TJ. Just because, you know, whatever.
As quickly in the first place.
Not really.
So are you sure?
You pay Paul a lot, TJ.
Do you know for a fact that it is the same guy who is the Amazing Atheist now? How do you know for sure?
Because because I do remember seeing him, and then I found him on YouTube or whatever.
I do remember seeing him.
It was disgusting what I saw. He was so rude to you, and he's such a rude person.
Oh my God.
He's so rude to you.
He's so rude.
It just keeps on coming, dude. The hits keep on coming, Brad.
And his proof is he remembered that he saw you, and then he saw you on YouTube, so that means he went to
high
school.
No random person is just going to find me and be like, look how rude he is to Brett Keene.
No, that's what happened.
Yeah, exactly.
And then call Brett and be like, Brett, got some info on this amazing atheist character. He's so rude to you. Yeah, and he's a rapist, too. Oh, he's a rapist. I'm not the one saying that,
you know
guys.
What?
This is this guy saying this.
There have been people, I think, that did know TJ in the past before all this YouTube shit that have contacted him. And it was obvious, like, when TJ instantly was like, oh, okay, I remember that person or something. This is, like, so, like, fucking nebulous. Like, I remember because I saw him. How can anyone believe this? And then the reason he did it was because he was being so rude to Brett Keene. I mean, like, Brett, why would you think anyone would follow this? Do you think, like, the people who actually do watch your shit are just fucking mentally retarded? They can't, like, put two and two together?
Well, yeah.
Well, they are.
Brett will
never
realize.
They're watching Brett Keene, so...
Yeah.
But, I mean, a lot of Brett Keene fans... Oh, go ahead.
I'm just saying, like, Brett doesn't realize his name is synonymous with dishonesty now. And nobody did that to Brett. Brett did that to himself by lying and cheating and cajoling and refabricating history to fit his narrative over and over again so much that not a single fucking person trusts anything that comes out of you, Brett. And for good reason. Look at this. Early on, before we even knew what was going on, we were like, TJ said it first. He was like, this sounds like a Brett Keene plant. And it turned out to be correct.
I mean, we don't have 100% proof, but I mean, I think everyone, even vaguely
anyone
familiar
with
this, is like,
yeah.
You know, this is pathetic and fake.
He's crazy. He's spreading this crazy stuff around, you know, so I have to expose him.
You feel like you have to expose him.
Sounds like a fucking script.
Yeah,
it is. Dude,
I feel like I have to expose the truth. He raped someone. Do you have any evidence? No, but I know I saw him.
This guy is sitting there with a piece of paper full of bullet-pointed bullet-pointed list of everything he's supposed to say.
I know.
And it's so obvious because Brett Keene just repeats what he said to, like, clarify it further.
It sounds like the acting in Plan 9 from Outer Space. It sounds like that bad.
And it's all hearsay, yeah. Too. It's like, I think I might have potentially heard someone say that TJ was kicked out because he was, like, he raped somebody.
It's like, yeah, no.
If you were writing a script for a movie where somebody was having a fabricated conversation, it would sound exactly like this. Like, yeah. Just completely to the letter. Like, he's doing this crazy stuff, and I feel I need to expose him. Like, what?
Exit stage right.
How do you actually call the police on him for this rape accusation?
No, not really. It was just maybe there was like a settlement. You know what that is, right? Where like the two families
what?
Or whatever, like
oh
when
God.
They, you know.
Where do we live? Like, okay, I will give you 3 goats for your son raping my daughter, and he shall marry her on the third day of spring. You know, like, what?
No.
That's not how it works. You don't just, like, come to an agreement if someone, like, commits a crime.
Yeah,
like,
they do that in civil cases. Right.
Yeah.
Well, in some countries they do things like that. Like I think it's like Pakistan or Saudi Arabia, like Middle Eastern countries. You can like pay blood money or something.
The same.
But no, not in America.
If there was ever a serious accusation and investigation of a rape involving TJ, he would have what you have, Brett, which is a fucking criminal record.
Yes.
Settle it with each other.
So you're saying
each
that
other.
His family had enough money to actually be able to settle out of court on a rape?
Yeah.
Oh, that's
yeah,
how the legal system
back
works.
To the whole scammer thing.
I want to hear the rest. Is that it?
Yeah, I think that might be it. Yeah.
It's over?
Yep.
Okay.
I mean, that's an airtight case against you, TJ.
Well, I...
Someone saw you, so you're guilty of rape.
I've been exposed. Obviously, I have raped many people. Paul can attest to this. I did fist him on the show.
He did.
Against his
he
will.
He did. Against my will, yes.
I am a sexual predator, and yeah, it's all true. Everything that guy said is true.
Yep.
Yeah, so I think what we're going to do here is we're going to pause for a break, probably like 5 to 10 minutes or so. We'll be right back. Don't go anywhere, because when we come back, we're going to do crazy people, and also we're going to open some fan mail that we got at our P.O. box, which is always interesting. So we'll be right back.
Are you hiring? Do you know where to post your job to find the best candidates? Posting your job in one place isn't enough to find quality candidates. If you want to find the perfect hire, you need to post your job on all of the top job sites. And now you can.
I have a close friend who owns a small business, and he was looking for some good people to run his office. That's when I told him about ZipRecruiter.com, where you can post your job to over 100 of the top job sites, including social media networks like Facebook and Twitter, all with a single click.
Yeah, and you can find candidates in any city, in any industry, nationwide. Just post once and you watch qualified candidates roll in to ZipRecruiter's easy-to-use interface, and you don't have to mess around with juggling emails or with frequent calls to your office. You just quickly and easily screen your candidates, rate them, and hire the right person fast.
Out today why ZipRecruiter has been used by over 800,000 businesses, and right now our listeners can post jobs on ZipRecruiter for free by going to ZipRecruiter.com/talent. That's ZipRecruiter.com/talent. One more time, to try it free, go to ZipRecruiter.com/talent.
Did we mention ZipRecruiter.com/talent?
I think we did.
Uh-huh.
Rubbing, 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 rubbing. Sorting a boner for the killing of the hobos in the city of Bowie. Feeling good, looking out the window, looking down the alley for a dirty old hobo. Yeah, I like the anal probing, shoving like the dirty dozen. Says the ladies in the dress of babies, mama said it's cause make it feel like a hobo. Time me down for anal probing, crossing over with blood running out my ass. I think it's funny, take a look at fucking bust you in the nuts like you're my lover. Fucking dirty hobo dick, it's awesome like the suck drip. Think twice about your trip, the hobo probing confidence. Building up the meaners up the moment, right your truck. Fucking hobo, hobo, hobo. Hobo, hobo, anal, 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 greasy, 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 up. Stick it, stick it, stick it, stick it in. Slide it up and down, slide it up and down.
Slide it all around.
Greasy, 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 greasy up. Stick it, stick it, stick it, stick it in. Slide it up and down, slide it up and down.
Slide it all around.
Greasy, 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 greasy up. Stick it, stick it, stick it, stick it in. Slide it up and down, slide it up and down.
Slide it all around.
Greasy, 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 greasy up. Stick it, stick it, stick it, stick it in. Slide it up and down, slide it up and down.
Slide it all around.
Greasy, 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 greasy up. Stick it, stick it, stick it, stick it in. Slide it up and down, slide it up and down.
Slide it all around.
Hobo, 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 hobo. Anal, 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 anal. Rubbing, 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 rubbing. Hobo, anal, pro.
Chickadee, 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 chew. What up, y'all? Fucking Paul is gone. Paul has abandoned the show.
Paul's dead.
Paul's like, fuck this shit, I'm gone, I quit. We got mail here. We're going to do some, we're open some mail.
You want to do that right now?
Yeah. Well, maybe we'll open a little right now and we'll open a little bit more at the end.
Let's just do it all
Let's
now.
Do it all now, fuck dude. Fuck
whatever,
you,
fine.
And then we'll do crazy people.
This one's from Brian Cunningham of Bowling Green.
Bowling Green, Kentucky.
Yeah, Kentucky.
Oh, TJ likes this.
What is this?
Oh, is it a luchador mask? Oh, is it a La Parca mask?
It is.
Yep.
Oh!
That's obviously for Ben.
Yeah, that is
obviously.
Awesome.
There's Twinkies.
For TJ.
They're smashed. Neat.
Do you remember La Parca? You ever seen him before?
No.
No.
Oh, man.
There's also a band called the Jasons, and they all wear Jason masks. Yeah. And let's see what they got in here. Hey, you fucks. I've been a fan since the beginning. I just wanted to say thanks for the countless hours of free entertainment, including some gifts. For Ben, a lucha mask of a particular Mexican wrestler. I bet he's the only peasant who can identify who that is.
Yep.
Correct.
You were right. You guys should talk about wrestling more often, by the way. Fuck the whiners. Oh, Ben's already wearing it. Also, for Ben is a CD by the Jasons. Not my band, I'm just a fan. They are a punk band with a Friday the 13th gimmick.
Cool.
All right.
That guy kind of looks like Fat Me.
Yeah, kind of.
Yeah.
And this is their first CD. They have two others out, blah, 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 blah. Some Twinkies for, I guess, anybody who wants them. And peace the fuck out. He says.
Have the smash Twinkies, TJ.
Thanks for giving Ben all the gifts, you fucking cocksucker.
Sweet. Sweet.
What a terrible fan.
Yeah. Pretty terrible.
Best fan ever. Thank you.
They're Scott, garbage. You got some, too. Why don't you open one of yours? Or am I just opening them all?
You're opening them all.
Oh, my God.
Why just save those Twinkies, dude. Save those Twinkies for me, Ben.
They're kind of crushed.
We'll save them for you, though.
I don't care. A delicious crushed Twinkie. What am I doing? I'm putting it in my mouth to crush it up with my teeth.
That is true.
Ben, why do you call all Quebecers French Canadians? And he can't spell Canadians. Not all Quebecers are French.
No. That's how they spell it.
All Canadian. Oh, it is?
Yeah, that's how they spell it.
Okay.
That's like.
Love the show. Love you guys.
The Montreal Canadians, they spell it that way.
Yeah, well, they want to know why you think they're all French.
They're not all French. Why? I mean, that's like saying everyone in Mexico is Mexican. Like, there's no people that are not Mexican in Mexico.
Oh, what I the mean, fuck is this?
That's the Quebec flag.
No, I know what it is. This is getting burned.
Here, I'll take it.
This is getting burned.
Burn it at
fucking
the hangout.
Quebec flag. Piece
I'm
of
going
shit.
To. Fan's getting fucking destroyed.
Okay. Do 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 probing. All right, this is a portrait of me.
That's pretty good.
Yeah, yeah.
That is good.
That is a pretty decent likeness of you.
Yep, I agree. Thank you. It feels like it's this is like the original. I can tell. I don't know what the. It looks like it might be. It's definitely not charcoal. It seems like it's not smudgy enough.
Oh, and furthermore. I mean, they're French Canadians that don't live in Quebec too. They can go other places.
All right, let's see. Dear TJ Kirk, I want to say first, I'm a huge fan of your shows. Couldn't write this penmanship atrocious. Name is Adam. Portrait of me. Blah 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 blah. He said he recorded a bunch of videos of himself drawing this shit. His channel is youtube.com/ Adam Height Official Illustrations. Height is spelled H-I-T-E. Adam Height Official Illustrations.
Terrible username.
And his Twitter is Adam Height Art. I think Height is his last name.
Yeah, I'm probably. Just saying because no one's going to fucking remember all that.
And then he offers me... he offers me his email if I want any private drawings.
Oh, my God.
Is he offering to draw porn for me? That's what it sounds
yeah.
like he's saying. That
nice.
Sounds cool.
That Dude. Sounds cool.
I like that.
Cool. Neat.
That does sound neat. What
neat.
The fuck's your problem?
Neat.
Neat.
Man, look at TJ's ugly fucking face for us to show.
I don't know what to do with this.
Yeah, set it somewhere
yeah,
else.
Yeah, it's fine back there for now.
Fine. What is this?
I don't fucking know. What is it?
Well, I thought I was going to open this one. Jesus.
Oh. Whatever. I don't fucking know.
All right, fine. I'm trying to open this shit. Someone fucking... Paul, tell a fucking amusing anecdote while this is going on.
I stay away from anecdotes now.
Pull your fucking weight, bitch.
How am I supposed to... what am I supposed to comment on? I'm not there. I can't see the packages.
Paul, you're such a fucking faggot. I don't know what we keep you around for. All
yeah,
right.
Seriously.
So let's see. This is some fucking book called The Emerald Tablet, Alchemy for Personal Transformation.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Wed into gold.
TJ, Scotty, Ben, and Paul, I appreciate your show. I like how you guys discuss controversial topics and make me laugh till tears squirt out of my eyes. Please accept this book. Read chapter one live on your show. No.
I'm fuck not, that.
What?
No.
Why the fuck?
Why?
What?
No.
All right. Sure.
Yeah,
why
let's
the fuck
read
not?
A chapter of a book.
Chapter 1, Gift from the Gods. Over the centuries, many esteemed philosophers have declared that the Emerald Tablet contains the sum of all knowledge, and a handful of seekers have reported actually seeing and touching the mysterious gemstone tablet. Yeah, it's going to be a riveting fucking show.
Yeah.
That would be awesome. Thank you for the suggestion. Damn retards. Fans are retarded, y'all.
Oh, and by the way, we forgot to show this, so I'm just going to show this really
Drunken
quick.
Drunken Peasants, P.O. Box 767, Dublin, Ohio, 43017.
Yeah, and there's also the address down in the description to this video, too. Send us stuff. We'll open it on the air.
Fucking bullshit. Ah.
Looking for a box of fake spiders for TJ.
That is what this is.
Sweet!
Yes!
Yes! Yes! Yes!
Oh, yeah, dude.
Yes.
Spiders.
Yes!
That's awesome.
Whatever.
Oh, man. We're going to put those all over your room, TJ.
Yeah, that's great. Sounds wonderful. Sounds
Ben
fucking wonderful.
So happy.
Oh, dude, you need to put him on this his fucking chair every time. Oh, this is great.
Shit away from me. Fucking weirdos. Fucking fake spider retards.
They're crawling all over you.
Okay, so this is what this guy felt the need to send this. It's Smoke Pan, Neb, I am the cold every day. I guess a smoke pan every day. And whatever. That's this drawing.
Look at yourself right there, man. You can see the spiders crawling on your shoulders and shit.
Oh, yeah. That's crazy. Fucking, dude, that's wild.
Spider that one's going to get you.
These fucking pieces of shit. DP, I was writing thank yous and thought you get one as well. Your podcast is one of the best, and it always makes my day. I'm sorry, max my day. There's no E. I hope to one day attend a meetup, but until then, take my mail. Bring back Stevie, you monsters. Hashtag nuke Scotty. P.S. TJ, don't take candy from strangers. Fuck you. I'll do what I want.
Whatever.
Whatever.
I do what I want.
Oh, check this out, dude.
Us as furries?
Yes.
What am I?
I don't know what you are. I think you're...
Am I an otter?
I don't know. I can't tell if you're an otter or what.
Yeah, no, it looks like some sort of cat.
Mine is bent, but I am a platypus.
Wow. That's awesome.
Scotty the egg bitch is... you're wearing some like BDSM shit, Scotty.
What the fuck?
I think you're a fox. I can't tell.
Yeah, it looks like a fox.
And then there's Scotty Cena.
Damn.
Who is also a fox. And there's no Paul one because Paul sucks, I guess.
Yeah, I didn't get a fursona. So
you feel
dear
left
drunken
out,
peasants, I hope you enjoy the furry badges I made before you inevitably throw them away. Keep up the good work. Alright. Thanks for the fucking weird furry art, I guess.
Didn't someone already send us this?
I think maybe so. Just Trumpilius J. Caesar. Yeah, it's a fucking... It's Julius Caesar, but with Trump.
Oh, wow.
We have been sent this before.
Thank you, though. Thanks for sending us stuff.
I got a giant box of candy today.
Dude. Guess what? Guess what we got?
What? Candy?
No, better than candy.
Eternal undying love?
Oh.
Wow.
Yeah, dude. It's eternal undying love.
By Brecky.
Dude, the picture, wow. Show the picture on the back.
At God, from GodHatesYou.org. And there, look at Brett Keane's
Oh, my fucking God.
Dude, that's priceless.
All right, we just opened and ran apart. The demon covered his eyes from the blinding light. Finally, Damien fell to his knees and reeled over, energy gone. He was on the brink of death. Could Damien possibly heal himself now? The demon chuckled as he stood over the fallen Damien. Look at you dying, sacrificing yourself for the life of a child who will die one day anyway. This is a cruel and unjust world, Damien. Not fit for a man like you. Let this world die. Don't fight for it. It's a lost cause. The demon shook his head. Damien looked up slowly at the demon. Never. Oh. Damien exclaimed. The demon kneeled down and stared Damien in the face. It's not your choice. It never was. Jezebeth grabbed Damien's hair with one hand. And with the other, dug into Damien's wound. Damien screamed in agony and then fell into unconsciousness from sheer pain. This is a masterpiece.
What a fucking tiring read.
All right, next one.
This person sent us.
Why is my fucking mic getting turned off?
That's a picture of him after he read the first chapter.
Yeah.
What?
He's got like his head up against a wall.
That's the picture of this guy after he read the first chapter of this book.
He's like sitting on the kitchen counter.
Yeah, drunken peasants, I hope you enjoy this fine piece of literature. I know I didn't. Okay, well, here you go. How dare you insult Brett Keane's masterpiece? Brett Keane's great.
Brett Keane has a different understanding.
Maybe we can get Brett Keane to sign this. Why is there an Atlantic County Library stamp on the side of it? Huh? See that?
Is it really from a library?
It does look like it is.
There's a stamp.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. That was in a library somewhere?
I feel bad for...
No fucking way.
That's wow, weird, dude. Though.
Okay, what the fuck is this? It says Tina Men...
Okay.
That's going to be some kind of fucking sex toy, dude.
Probably.
I think it's diapers.
Huh? Okay. Oh, my God.
We need diapers. Scotty's always shitting himself.
Man diapers.
Protective underwear.
Nice.
Cool. Now I don't have to worry about that anymore. I can just piss myself on the go.
Yep. More breaks in the middle of the show. Just go, man.
I mean, if anyone needs that, it's probably Scotty, because he's the one that's always leaving to go to the bathroom.
Yeah, I need that, man.
Oh, my God.
I don't know.
Is it a bomb? Find out now.
Yeah.
All right. This does sound
sketchy.
Unusual.
Oh, shit.
It just says DP viewer.
Oh, no.
Ben's backing away.
Yeah, that sounds
good. What are you doing?
Pushing your head on the way.
You got to die, too. I think this is probably a box full of actual live spiders.
Yeah, dude. Just baby spiders come pouring out of it.
Oh, it's actually... Ugh. I used to have this.
Is it a metal lunchbox?
It is a lunchbox. It's a lunchbox I used to have back in the day.
Oh, yeah, dude, you did.
But I lost it along the way somewhere, and now it has been replaced.
Cool. Is there a thermos in it?
It sounds like there's something in it. It doesn't sound like a fucking thermos, though.
Spiders.
Spiders.
Tarantulas, dude.
Oh, shit!
Holy shit!
Oh, damn.
Ben, do your dwarf voice.
You are without honor.
That's awesome. This
here's Khan. There's a Khan action
Sigmund
figure.
Sigmund Freud action figure.
Nice.
A Jesus board cube. Action figure. A Jesus action figure. And a copy of The Confessions by Jean-Jacques Rousseau. So that's neat. Thank you.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Everything about this is pretty neat. We appreciate it. This lunchbox looks like it actually has been used to bash someone's fucking brains in. I think they were just getting rid of evidence.
Is there any more?
Is that it?
We done? Is that everything?
No. We got...
There's a few more things, TJ.
We have one more thing?
Yeah.
At least one more thing.
All right. This is from Tara Babcock.
Yeah, actually, Tara Babcock.
Who was a guest on our show. A very silent guest. But she had them titties, so who cares?
I don't think she was familiar with our format.
This is a giant penis mask.
Cool.
Yeah.
Cool.
Sweet.
Ben, sweet. Here you go.
Am I supposed to wear that?
Yeah.
No, maybe you are.
Is that for me?
And there is a... I don't know what the fuck... It's a fake beard, I guess. So if Paul, if you ever end up having to shave your beard for one of these weird drunken peasants' bets...
All right.
You're covered.
It'll never happen, but it's good to know that there's a backup strategy.
Oh, yeah, there's definitely something else in the works in case you need it, you know? And then there's some kind of bondage gear, and that's it.
There's a note.
Oh, I see. Oh, this is only for Ben, so all this stuff is yours, Ben. To
damn.
Ben, may these assorted masks build your sex appeal. XOXO Tara Babcock.
Damn,
and she says, you're welcome for the exceptional fan art. And here's the fan art.
Nice.
Damn, she Ben.
She knows
Babcock
her.
Wants a... Dude, she wants you, dude. She wants that dick.
Sounds like it.
Bab wants the cock from Ben.
Damn.
Anyway.
And maybe Paul as well. Who knows?
I doubt it. That's a doubtful thing.
Nah, man. She's got a thing for you, Paul.
So I think that's everything, right?
She has a fetish for men who are round as a ball, she told me.
Whoa.
Oh,
Paul.
It reminds her of her tits.
Well, in that case, I can provide. Because I am round as fuck.
Paul, a bunch of people requested I draw you in the last batch of books I had. So whenever I drew you, I literally just started by drawing a huge ball.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
And then I just add your features onto it.
Oh, that works.
It was fun. I enjoyed it.
All right, time for crazy people.
Let's do it. Scary.
You're a rapist.
Right. Oh my God, he's a piece of shit.
I didn't say it. It was that one guy that called. I was just planning on talking about the Pokemon.
He should make a different accusation every time he appears at the end of the Crazy People segment. Just like, rapist, pedophile.
What else could be?
Traitor to your country.
My father, like son.
Attack my family. Called my child a water-headed idiot.
But they are.
Tax fraud.
Actually, you know, Paul, not Paul, you know, Brett, the girl I raped was actually Dawn.
Dawn.
Dun, my, dun, dun.
Oh my
no.
God.
You th- those kids you, those kids you think are yours, they're actually mine.
Dude, they're DJ's waterheads. Idiots.
Yeah. I have hydrocephalus too, and that's why my kids have it. You know?
Cephalus?
Isn't that
is
what
that,
it's called?
Is that how they say it now?
Hydrocephalus? Is that
no. Hydro. You have cephalus.
Syphilis. Yeah. I have hydrocephalus.
Hydrocephalus.
Yeah.
Like wet syphilis.
Is okay. That, yeah, it's like syphilis you get from water.
No, it's just syphilis that's really wet.
Oh. Nice.
Well, they said it does cause insanity and delusional behavior, so there you go.
Damn. You know, yeah. You've seen how I behave.
I know. I've seen it.
That's what I'm saying.
I've seen it.
Oh, yeah.
I've seen it.
Oh, yeah.
All right, so here, this video's a gem right here.
A gem.
Yep.
You know, I told myself I wasn't going to make another video while I was on vacation, but I was watching the memorial service this morning for the Dallas officers, and I just decided I have to make this video. And I don't like making these types of videos because, like I said, I can't edit myself because I have no editing software, no computer, no nothing with me. But I wanted to talk about the hypocrisy of what he said. In his speech, he talked about how the Founding Fathers gave us the type of country that can fight against tyranny. And he goes on to talk about, how we have this elective republic that can, you know, vote for our best interests and we can make changes without violence, etc. But he neglected to say that one of the major things that our Founding Fathers did so that we can fight against tyranny is gave the citizens the right to be as well armed as the military, law enforcement, the government, etc. Completely neglects to mention that part. Kind of, like I said, it's a great deal of hypocrisy there when you say that.
I mean, like, the citizenry is not allowed to be as armed as the military. Nope. You know, no one's going to let you have a fucking, like, F-16.
Dude, that's like, yeah, that's the most vast and broad interpretation of the Second Amendment I've ever heard. I mean, quite literally, it's just like, I should be able to have whatever they have.
Yeah, I mean, that's ludicrous.
Like, why would you need a tank? You know what I mean? Like, a fully operational tank. Like, what would the purpose for this guy to be? So he can keep the government in check?
Just in case the government comes, I got something to fight back with.
Oh, the way that the Founding Fathers wanted us to fight against tyranny was to be able to vote, you know, for politicians that are then controlled by big money interests, corporations, and, you know, big donors, not for the people by the people themselves. That is, you know, that's a big hypocritical thing to say. So you can't say one without the other. If you acknowledge the fact that they gave us the right to vote to fight tyranny, then you have to acknowledge the fact that they gave us the right to defend ourselves and to be well-armed to fight tyranny. But you don't see him ever doing that. And then I wanted to talk about how he went even further and just blatantly lied about how we flood cities with so many guns and that it's easier for a teenager to get a hold of a Glock than it is a computer or a book. Where in the world is it easier for a teenager to get a hold of a gun?
Well, according to a video we watched on the show, a gun show is a place where a teenager can get a gun
also,
pretty
easily.
Also,
there's tons of people that they like their relatives and family members and friends own guns that they just leave lying around and then someone just grabs one.
Yeah.
Glock than it is a computer or a book. That doesn't exist anywhere in this world, in this country at least.
Yeah, I mean, I guess it's really kind of ridiculous to say it's easier to get than a book, because a book
is
easier.
Yeah, a book is easier to get.
A computer, though, I can definitely see it being easier to get a gun than a computer, because a computer is way more expensive than a fucking gun.
not in this country. It probably does exist in some places like Africa, etc., South Africa, but it doesn't exist here. It might exist in some, you know, Middle Eastern countries, but it doesn't exist here. That kind of place does not exist here, where a teenager can get a Glock easier than they can get a book or a computer. So I just want to point out
that hypocrisy, because it kind of made me mad.
Yeah,
that
I'm saying,
you would, for one,
yeah,
that you would use the funeral of these fallen police officers to spout your political rhetoric that are based nothing but more than baseless lies that you would.
Dude, I never understand this shit. Like, how after this tragedy happened, they're trying to politicize it. Like, it inherently is a political issue.
Oh, they get so old when people say
you're
that.
You're so dumb. I hate these people who fucking toe that shitty line. It's like, I'm sorry, but what society is going to do about this is a political issue. You can't help but make it political. It is political. What do you want the politicians to do? Just be like, we ain't got nothing. This ain't the purview of politics. Do you have any idea how outraged America would be if they just kind of like shrugged their shoulders and went, eh, not our job.
Well, with gun control, it's kind of what they've done.
I mean, I think that one side has definitely done that.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Well, they control the legislative body, so, you know, that essentially controls the laws.
Oh, yeah. I wish this guy had straightened my teeth when he drew this picture. You know? Why do you got? I know my teeth are really like that in real life, where one front tooth goes down lower than the other. But you could have fucking taken some artistic liberties there.
Well, when you do realism, you don't do cosmetic corrections.
Bullshit. Not true at all.
TJ wants a court painter that'll paint him like flatteringly.
That's what I'm saying. Like court painters back in the day, they painted photorealistic shit, but they exaggerated you. They made you look good because they know you're paying top dollar for that fucking painting.
Well, you paid nothing for that, though.
I know. I paid him with entertainment for years, Scotty.
Oh, whatever.
Use that opportunity to do that, and then that you would make up shit like that whole, oh, it's easier to get a Glock than a book or a computer, because that's garbage. The only people that would believe that are morons. So I can't believe that you would do that.
Why do you even care about that point?
So if you want to talk about what the founders wanted, and you want to talk about what the founders did, well, how about one thing they spelled out implicitly, and that's that the Second Amendment shall not be infringed. You don't seem to care what the founders thought about that. So, and obviously you don't care what the founders thought about our political system either, because you are one of the big...
I mean, I honestly don't give a fuck about what the founders thought about much of anything.
Their time has come and passed.
Yeah, they lived fucking 200-something years ago. They're dead. They're gone. They don't understand today's fucking political climate. They don't understand the problems that we face today. To defer to their wisdom is fucking retarded.
Well, I mean, hardcore Second Amendment advocates don't care about what the founders wanted either, because they don't want to talk about the fucking object of the Second Amendment, which is a well-regulated militia. The term well-regulated is in the Second Amendment.
Communism. Yeah, they do tend to gloss over well-regulated, don't they?
They do.
They also don't seem to give a fuck if the First Amendment's violated over and over again.
That one ain't as important.
Biggest puppets of big industry. You're one of the biggest puppets of the insurance agencies I've ever seen. So you, Hillary Clinton, all of you, right, left.
I mean, the fundamental flaw of this shit is, like, the First Amendment matters not because the founders thought it mattered, but because we can actually make an argument for why it matters. The Second Amendment, like, yeah, you can make an argument for why it matters, but I can also make an argument for why it doesn't matter and why it's just fucking stupid. I mean, I don't think that is a fundamental right of people. I don't think it should be anyway. I don't think that should be the second most important thing, is that we can have guns. Especially in a world where the government outguns any fucking private citizen, like, just by a ridiculous margin. If the government wants to fuck with you, your guns ain't gonna fucking save you from shit.
Yeah, the guns are not on the receiving ends of the bullets that these fucking people fire off. The citizenry is. So your bulwark against the tyranny of the government ain't working too well.
Yeah,
so that argument falls a little flat with me. Sorry.
The Branch Davidians at fucking Waco had guns. Didn't save them. The Cliven Bundy's kids had guns. They still fucking got fucked. Doesn't matter. You can fucking have your little militia, and you can have your guns, and you can think you're gonna fucking take on the government, but when it comes right down to it, the government's gonna fuck your shit up no matter what. Because they're better supplied, they have better resources, they have way more money. You don't stand a fucking chance. You don't stand a fucking chance.
Republican, Democrat, none of you care about what this country was meant to be, what the founders set up to do. That you don't care about protecting our freedoms. If you care,
I don't give a fuck because you know what?
Yeah, why don't we think for our fucking selves and not just be like the founders said this? Like, okay, why are you treating them like them like they're messiahs, like they're fucking prophets? Like, okay, we have to follow what these people thought. It's like maybe then when everyone agreed that's what was the best course of action, sure, but times change.
If you want to talk about what the founders thought, Thomas Jefferson, one of the architects of this fucking country, said that we should not be beholden to what the founders thought. He said that that the country should grow and evolve. He actually said that there should be a new constitution every fucking 20 years.
Yep.
So that we're not slaves to fucking some old antiquated fucking moral suppositions and shit.
Exactly.
So fuck what the founders, I mean, like, fuck the founders, all right? Fuck them. They're fucking old, dead, stupid sons of bitches who weren't right about shit.
They founded it, though.
Who gives a shit what they did? It was a long fucking time ago. I mean, they've been fucking elevated beyond fucking reason. It's insane. I mean, they were smart guys who had some fucking compelling, original fucking thoughts. And they fucking formed a new country.
They were also products of their time. And things that exist now that didn't exist then are not compensated for in the Constitution. That's why the amendments exist, is because the founders wanted the Constitution to be a mutable document. They wanted it to change with the times.
Yes.
They accepted the fallibility of man, basically, and it's the whole point.
About protecting our freedoms, you'd make sure that no police department had more armaments than the people. No police department should be able to take out an entire city with just 20 of them because of the armaments they receive. Citizens should be just then as what well the fu- armed then what, as their police then, and as...
Then what's the fucking point of having a police department? What's the point? What's the point of having a police department that can't fight anybody? That can't protect you from somebody because everybody that they go to is just as well armed, if not more well armed, than they are. They can't bring a tank because, you know, the guy's got a fucking tank.
Yeah, I mean,
it's paranoia, too. He's basically saying, like, 20 cops are just going to destroy an entire city. It's like, what? What's the incentive to destroy the city? They're just like, you know, we got to crush this rebellion. People like him are rising up. We have such armaments that we can just take them all out. I mean, I guess it could happen, but it just seems far-fetched at this point.
Sometimes as their military, even. So although I'm not as worried about the military. I don't think every citizen, don't worry, I'm not thinking everyone should have an H-bomb or, you know, a nuclear bomb or anything like that.
Okay. So you're selective. War,
we should be able to take our numbers.
Well, but they have H-bombs. The government has hydrogen bombs. They have atomic weapons. They have fucking ICBMs. We need those or we're going to be a fucking disadvantage if the people rise up.
He's saying that we need to be able to have we never be able to at least have the advantage in a ground war. It's like you don't because they have aerial strike capabilities and all sorts of like missiles and weapons and shit.
What a fucking idiot.
Have.
Yeah, we don't line up in a big empty field and take shots at each other anymore. That's not how war works anymore. That's how it worked when the founders wrote the document. We'd all stand in a field, you know, half a mile apart and shoot fucking lead at each other until one of us gave
Fire
up.
Fire the first volley!
Yeah, now it turns out that, like, if there's a bunch of fucking raving lunatic rednecks with guns rampaging through a city and we have to fucking quell the uprising, something tells me they're not going to send troops.
Come. But if you give it to where the small little amount of armaments you allow us to have can't overcome anything, if you only allow us to have like little semi-automatic pistols or single-shot revolvers, you know, and then we can't overcome 1,000 of us, couldn't overcome 2 guys in an armored
the most
vehicle
powerful,
with that.
All right, this the most is powerful bullshit. Gun that you can purchase, the most powerful fucking bullet-firing gun ever made would not protect you from the fucking government.
A fucking
so
full
this
auto.
Argument... Yeah, I mean, like, whatever you want. Like a fucking 50 cal, you know, chain-firing fucking cannon that they put on top of a fucking Humvee in Iraq. That's not going to protect you from the government.
It's not going to protect
so
you from a hellfire missile.
No, your whole fucking argument falls apart, and it boils down to, I just like guns. I want to be able to have guns. They don't really protect me from nothing, but I want a gun.
At least that would be an honest fucking argument.
No, this guy's going to stand up to the might of the Hellfire missile. What are you talking about? He's going to shoot out of the air.
Just takes a fucking old West six shooter and just shoots a government drone out of the sky.
So that's just not the way the founders wanted this country to be. So I just wanted to make this video to say, like I said, that it was such a hypocritical moment to sit up there and talk about what the founders wanted and how we're supposed to fight tyranny. And then with
your
next
breath,
you
just said you know.
Tell lies about the Second Amendment to undermine what the founders wanted. The way one of the main things the founders set up for us to be able to defend our liberties with and to fight against tyranny with. So, you know, you just lose credibility every time you open your mouth lately. And I don't understand why.
It's like, interpret the will of the founders.
Push through your gun control because it's your main thing. It's like that's what you've been told by the insurance companies.
It's Obama's main thing.
What? And he's been told it by insurance companies? Okay.
That they want rid of, because they don't want people out there with the means to hurt themselves, because then they have to pay out on policies. So they want everyone to be disarmed,
it's
helpless,
pretty out
little
there.
Sheep wrapped in bubble wrap, what? And you're helping them do that. So, because liberty and freedom is never safe. You're never safe when you're free.
Look, if I'm ever genuinely concerned about protecting my fucking liberty or freedom, I'm not going to come to you and your ilk to do it. You do not look like a warrior for liberty or freedom. You look like a fucking retard. So I don't need your protection. I don't want you protecting my liberty and freedom. You're not. You clearly have been demonstrated to not be protecting anything because you've admitted that the government has weapons that are far beyond the capabilities of any gun. So
it's just part of being free. So you kind of have to choose one or the other. And if you choose safety over freedom, like Ben Franklin says, you really don't deserve either and you won't have either.
Oh, my God.
So choose freedom. And don't listen to this crap.
Choose freedom. What does that even mean?
Shame on you for saying that kind of crap. Shame on you for politicizing this. And shame on you for praising the founders with one hand while you still actively undermine their whole ideas. And then totally ignoring and then even desecrating what they say with the other hand. Alright. One of these days, I'll learn how to work this.
One of these days, you'll buy editing software.
Yeah, I was about to say.
One of these days, you'll learn how to construct a cogent argument, too, but I'm not holding my fucking breath.
I don't think that day's gonna come.
Yeah.
Alright.
Not likely. That's the end of that.
Let's move on to whatever Ben's got next here. Jesuit women feel defrauded by Miss Universe contest.
Okay.
Sweet.
What? Oh.
You know, these Jesuits are terrorists. They need to go. They are losing in court with my men, and part of Brent's defense is that he's not a snobby rich celebrity like his clone and Lauren McBride. He drove taxi cabs in New York as a struggling actor before he became famous. So he relates to people like me who have talent but not fame. Combine this with the fact that I won or placed high in a Miss Universe pageant. Nobody believes the story from the Jesuits that my men are playboys and only toy with me as a mentally ill woman in order to keep up their playboy lifestyle without consequences. My men are absolutely committed to me and think I'm the most gorgeous woman in the universe. And that Jesuits have targeted them with rapes and Jesuits stalker women like Lauren McBride, Camilla Alves, Morgan Brown, etc. for this reason. The Jesuits are losing and they are furious. This Istanbul airport attack is obviously a statement over my Miss Universe win and their
Istanbul
loss in court. Jesuits need to burn in hell for this.
About fucking time.
Yeah.
These guys just keep up the appearance of being these Hollywood playboys.
I thought her Jesuit shield was protecting the entire Earth.
So. Oh, I think the shield must have weakened.
The shield has gone down. Yep.
I'm just glad that she's added, you know, former almost Miss Universe pageant winner to her list of credentials here. It's good
almost
to know.
Oscar winner.
Her long resume.
You know, take a look at this obvious Photoshop at Lori McBride's IMDb page. Look at the legs. Lori McBride must really have a very low public opinion of public intelligence. If she's so hot, why does she have to resort to Photoshop? With photos like this where she looks like a midget, is it any wonder she can't get anywhere in a Miss Universe contest? Actually, I think she's about 5'7". But I can also attest to her personality, which is brash and vulgar. She loves words like fuck and bitch and has a laugh like a demon from hell.
Wow.
Okay.
She's describing herself.
This is just taking gossip to a whole new level. Like, you know, Lori is just Satan incarnate, and she hates Brett. And, you know, it's like, what are you talking about?
Trump Cord Schuler 2016.
Wow. I'd like to point out that there's just as much veracity in the allegations that Gail is making than there were in the Brett Keene video we watched earlier. He Correct. May as well be saying that TJ is a fucking Jesuit clone who photoshops his legs out of pic. What are we supposed to be seeing in this picture that's obviously photoshopped again?
It's obvious.
The legs?
I'm looking at it.
I can't tell.
I'm looking at the whole thing in the other Photoshop, and there's nothing.
It's chopped, man.
There's
Her
nothing
hand
unusual.
Looks a little weird, but...
Yeah, the hand looks weird, too. Look at the legs, too. Those legs are not real legs.
Definitely
oh, yeah, those are obviously
not
bullshit.
A refined lady. Though she may outdo Camilla Alves at being photogenic, Camilla has a more pleasing public personality. Of course, both Lori and Camilla are like Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. They are truly evil and violent women who parade as hot women... claiming men drool after them.
Well, hold on. What? Hold on. Isn't that what you do?
Yeah.
But Gail deserves it.
That's your MO, Gail, is talking about how men drool after you and fantasize about you, and all these hot men from all over the fucking entertainment and political sphere worship at the altar of you.
This is a whole situation.
I don't know. I've never heard Lori McBride's talk, but I fucking seriously doubt she goes around talking about how hot she is and how men just drool at her feet and stuff.
No.
She does.
So insecure, they feel the only way to get a man is to rape him, relying totally on their bodies as the weapon to get a man, as if that is all you need to land a man.
And Gail knows.
Then they get wicked Jesuit clones of my men to cooperate with their charade and appear with them in public together, where loads of pictures are taken for publicity purposes.
Gail is a touch
denial.
They
have a terrorist mindset, and that they're willing to suffer the pains of pregnancy like a suicide bomber, even when they did not get pregnant with my men through normal sexual relations. Bomb rape is Camilla's forte. Drug rape is Lori Reed's.
It's not Lori.
Lori. It's Lori.
Drug rape.
Lori.
Yeah, that's her preferred method of rape. It's not the only one that she'll use, but
she learned it from Cosby.
Yeah, so basically she goes out, they go out with the clones, but then she's actually really married to Brett, and then she's like raping Brett.
Brent.
Oh, Brent, yeah. Pretty hot, but Brett.
I'm
Brett
Steiner
situation.
A man. This disqualifies any woman from entering a beauty contest, let alone placing in one. Even with Photoshop, Lori certainly does not look hot enough to place in a Miss Universe beauty pageant.
But you do.
Yeah, but you do.
Okay. But you do, Gail.
Look at Gail. TJ, I mean, come
Every
on,
man's
let's be honest.
Dream.
Gail, let's be honest, TJ.
Gail is the hottest piece of ass this side of the Mississippi, y'all.
There was that one night, TJ, I walked in and you were just looking at Gail. And that was like, there's no words exchanged. You weren't even doing that. You were just like, isn't Gail the most beautiful woman you've ever seen? Yep. She should win Miss Universe. And that's when I just left the room.
Yep. I'm on the other side of the Mississippi, and I can tell you she's the hottest one over here, too. So,
damn.
All right, let's move on.
You won fine-ass bitch, Gail.
Here's another pretty crazy video.
Gail, dude.
This is Cooking Up a Beat Part 3, The Stairway to Heaven.
I'm feeling it.
These are some sick fucking jams, dude.
You guys are lucky that Evan is battle.
I know, seriously.
I thought I could beat Box, but this Evan puts me to shame.
What the fuck are we watching? What is this?
This amazing. Is cooking up a beat three. This Stairway is great. To heaven.
Man, cooking up a beat one was way better than cooking up a beat three. You need to go back to cooking up a beat, Evan.
Yeah, because he was using like what utensils from his kitchen to cook lots up a beat.
Yeah, that made sense. There was like a thing there.
It seems like he had a better camera back then too.
That one broke.
This one just sounds like somebody trying to sing along with like a 70s love song while having their mouth full of oatmeal. This is not...
Speed it up, Ben.
It just goes on. How long did he sit here and do this?
9 minutes and 22 seconds.
Oh my god. 9 minutes. Dude, this is it. Dude, we've discovered it. Dude, it's a song about motherhood, dude.
Yeah.
We just had to slow it down, dude. Evan LaFlavor, you're my friend forever, dude.
LaFlavor,
fucking genius. What a god among men.
He is. No, well, he's the biological father of Jesus Christ.
He is. He's God.
Sorry.
Yeah, he actually is God. Yeah, Evan LaFlavor.
I can't even use the god amongst men thing with him because he's literally God.
He is the God.
He is, dude.
It just sounds like the soundtrack of like somebody trying to sing while giving a blowjob. It's pretty amazing.
Alright. TJ, you should do a video like this. TJ, this is like a video you should aspire to make.
Dude, he just usurped Blueberry Pie as the best video on YouTube. TJ.
Everybody love the Blueberry Pie.
You've gotta one up him.
All right, next video. This is actually a video from someone that we watched on the show that we did earlier today, which will air in a week or two.
Yeah.
These guys don't know who it is yet, but they'll recognize her, I think. So here we go.
Hello and welcome back to Just Kiss My Frog. Today, in the selfish vein that I make most of my content, I'm making
a video.
She was
wearing glasses last time.
Yeah. I've been around, so I could have watched it. So when the whole time travel thing happens, I'm going to really enjoy this video. I'm so excited to watch it. Today I'm going to be talking about the top 5 reasons you should delete people from Facebook. Now, I have the opposite of resting bitch face. I have resting nice face. I try and be as nice to as many people.
Oh, my God. Come on now. I have resting nice face.
I hate to tell you this, but no.
No, you don't. No one just looks at you and is like, that's a really nice person. That's not happening. And even if that were to happen, you're not really a good person to ask if that's the case. Because, I mean, you're basically just using your own perception of yourself.
Possible in the world as I can. But very recently, and I'm talking about in the last 3 months, I've come to terms with the fact that being a nice person isn't just a choice where it's like, I will be nice to everybody. Okay, easy done. Being nice is a skill, and it's a strategy-based skill. And as like a human with only like a certain capacity for like life, you have to work out the best ways to be nice to the most amount of people that you can in the deepest way that you can. And sometimes that involves deleting people from Facebook. I know. Number one.
That is nonsense.
Yeah.
That's fucking gibberish. If you want to delete people from Facebook, you have a right to do that. There can be people who are annoying or whatever, but don't say it's because you're trying to maximize your niceness.
You almost know for certain these are going to be frivolous reasons.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Of course.
Of course they are.
You are not invincible. As somebody who's like a 20-something, I think there's lots of people that want to encourage you and tell you that you can do anything. And that is really empowering, but also sometimes results in people having croaky voices and doing everything and working 24/7 because they have this idea that they can do anything. But that often to my ears sounds like you can do everything, which are completely different things. I've been spending this year trying to not be
I'm sorry, what does this have to do with anything?
Yeah, this is just like her rambling, and this is just like the reason she wants you to watch the video. It's like, there's 5 reasons why you should delete someone from Facebook, and then you listen to the reasons, and it's just like, what is this rambling nonsense?
Be so skeptical about the term self-care. If you're trying to be a more awesome person and a kind person, that often results, if you're doing it well, that people want to be around you and people want to include you in things. And that is like amazing, and like I will never stop being grateful for that happening. But moving to London and meeting even more people to have in my life than I already had meant that I very fast realized that I couldn't be everywhere and I had to make some choices. Those old choice things, making you a character and your own person.
You don't have to delete people from Facebook that you don't want to do things.
She had to make choices.
You could just say like,
she's moved on.
I don't have time to do that.
She's moved on, TJ.
Okay.
Life decisions.
Yeah, she's moved on.
Gotcha. All right.
It kind of sounds to me like I moved away from my hometown. Now I'm somewhere new and now I'm cutting ties with all the people from my old life. Basically.
Someone in the chat said she's crazier than Gail.
I don't know about that, but.
Listen, damn it. So my first point is about boundaries. It's about choosing where you won't be so you can choose where you will be. And Facebook is one of those places that you don't have to turn up to. The only places that I would ever say you need to turn up to or be in or be present in are the places that you've already said you're going to be, and usually they're physical places. So if I go for coffee with my friend Zana, I will try and turn up. She'll tell you, I will try and turn up. I do always turn up, eventually. I'm a very late person. There are lots of physical spaces that you promise to other people that you will be in, and then promising to people that you'll also be in these like cyber spaces is like a lot of appointments to turn up to and a lot of places to go every day. And sometimes...
Can someone... Right. Does anyone have like a hammer that they can beat me over the head with or something like that? Because
I can go buy one if you want.
I mean, this is like, wow, I need to die right now. I can't take this. This is fucking...
Yeah.
It's dead.
It's dead.
Ignore, like, fuck. She just ignores the fact that, like, we live in a society now where this type of electronic communication is how a lot of friendships and family relationships play out. Your physical presence is not required for you to, keep an appointment you made with anybody. Like, block whoever you want on Facebook, but there really is no difference between saying, hey, man, I'll call you on Skype at 7 o'clock and not showing up, and doing that in person.
No.
You have to see Facebook and places like it as physical places that you have to visit, and you have to schedule in time for that, and you have to, you know, make sure you're going to be there if people expect you to be, or manage people's expectations when you're not.
I've never had a fucking appointment on Facebook.
Yeah.
No.
Just never happened. I'll be on Facebook at 3 p.m.
Maybe if you're doing like a Q&A or something.
Yeah, I guess.
Number two, balance of the private and the public. Especially if you're somebody like me who has a more public online presence on a lot of other platforms, like Instagram and Twitter. I'm very, like, anyone can follow me on those, and sometimes I share quite personal things. So they are public spaces that I am inhabiting because I enjoy it and because it's part of my, like, role as a content creator, and it's part of, like, my...
This is hideous.
Yeah, this is awful.
Just look at that.
All right. So, just a reminder to everyone, this will be our last actual regular episode before we do the meetup on Sunday. We're going to be doing some cool stuff down there prior to the meetup. Paul and TJ are going to taste three different types of chili dogs and decide their favorite one. Also,
we're going to figure out the best chili dog in Toledo.
Yes, out of those three, which most people agree are the best. I'm sure someone will comment, like, so-and-so, you know, like, someplace I've never heard of.
Those are the top three.
Those are the top three.
Aside from those, which is the best.
Also,
all of Toledo waits with bated breath for us to make our verdict.
Yes. Yes. And then, also, we may do a stop by Video Game Underground and JC's Comics.
Video Game Underground.
Nice. I'm going to buy a video game there. I don't care what it is.
For sure.
Yeah, he's got a lot of retro shit there.
Super Metroid by Super Metroid.
Oh, dude, we're definitely going to Video Game Underground. Come on.
Video Game Underground has the best video games in town.
If he has, like, a new copy of Diablo 1, I'll buy that in a heartbeat. Like, someone
Oh, I'm sorry, dude. Someone said, rip DP for, like, a week. No, dumbass. No. Even though we're going to be off for a week... We're actually, we're only going to miss one episode. We had the potential to miss five if we didn't do anything, but we've been doing, you know, we've been doing makeup shows. Yeah. And those will air. Yeah. Yep.
We're going to do it.
Get some fucking facts, buddy.
Get you some facts in your dumb ass.
Some fucking knowledge in your fucking brain.
And the private show is going to be this Friday at 4 o'clock.
Four p.m.
Yeah, with Paul here in the studio.
And me and Paul are going to have us a rap battle.
Yep, it's going down. I'm getting Paul off a plane and then fucking destroying TJ in a rap battle.
Prepare for ego death, Paul.
And after that private show, I'm going to head up to Toledo. So it's going to be crazy.
No one cares what you're going to do, Ben.
Yeah, Ben.
People care what I do.
You're a dumb
faggot. Do that in your personal time.
People care what
Ben.
I do.
You're a dumb, stupid faggot, Ben. No one likes you.
Aw.
No one fucking likes you, Ben.
Aw.
Play a video. Fuck
Why,
you,
thank
Crispy.
You.
What do you know, boy? You ain't know nothing.
I don't know, TJ. I think twice as many people come to the meetup I organized.
Shit, got you there, TJ.
It's in a fucking area with, like, cities all around it.
Okay! I know.
Oh, TJ.
And your event is all ages.
That is true. That is true. I'll give him that point.
You had the opportunity to make your event however you'd like.
Mm. Yeah. Yep. I did not. I had to go with whatever venue I could actually get.
Oh, I don't know, TJ. I secured a venue relatively quickly.
Whatever, Ben.
I wanted to say that the people in the chat are chanting for Vader. I mean, do we give the people what they want?
You know, I suggested that earlier, and TJ's like, yeah. So I don't know.
They want Vader.
Can you see how much I'm coughing without smoking anything?
You cough all the time.
I'll pick up the slack for our family. Our must be... Pack this, TJ. You worthless fuck.
We might have to grind some up.
Pack this, TJ. You're fucking pathetic.
You know what? We have to grind some.
I hate shit. Fuck that.
You know what I mean? So. What kind of fucking brother do I have, man? Seriously.
We'll play this other video here while I get Vader prepared, and then we'll end the night with Vader.
As if you gave a shit if I had a sore throat, TJ. You just laugh at me.
So what? I wouldn't be fucking egging you on to hit some bong. Like, you pushed.
Yeah, you would. What the fuck? Yes, you would. That's totally in your character.
TJ, I would not.
TJ, dude. You do the same shit to him, dude.
Scotty will get this. Scotty a pussy. Scotty don't. Scotty can't handle this. Scotty won't take a dab. Scotty won't do dabs because Scotty can't handle a dab.
Bullshit. I don't say nothing like
that. Also, Scotty made me late. Scotty's never on time.
Oh, man, I fucking
always
about...
Always gotta do something extra all the time.
I outdid TJ on dabs one time, man, but it was fucking brutal. Like, it was fucking brutal.
Do I have to, like, cut this to open it?
Yeah, it's sealed.
Pretty much. Video game underground.
All right, so we'll play this while I get Vader prepared.
Awesome.
Neat.
For such a cherished human right, there sure are a lot of us who don't understand it. So here are five misunderstood things about free speech.
All right, so Steve Shives is going to teach us what we need to know about free speech.
Finally.
So shut the fuck up and listen, everybody.
I'm going to.
Number one, free speech is more than the First Amendment. We Americans tend to treat the concept of free speech as synonymous with the First Amendment to our Constitution, which states that Congress shall make no law abridging the freedom of speech. I myself, when discussing this issue, have often pointed out that the First Amendment defines the relationship between citizens and their government, not citizens and each other. But the concept of free speech is much broader than the First Amendment to the Constitution of my country. And, just as importantly, it's much more complex than the I should get to say whatever I want principle that is promoted by certain people on the internet.
It's more complex because you've decided to make it more complex. It really isn't more complex than I can say whatever I want.
Yeah,
that's
freedom of
speech. That's kind of the definition of freedom of speech.
Freedom of speech and freedom of thought means that, yes, you can say and think whatever you want. You're not allowed to do whatever you want, but say and think, yes, you're allowed to do whatever you want. That is freedom of speech. You cannot...
Wait, he's under an basically under the purview of that, legally, you know, freedom of speech just talks about between your relationship between you and the government, not just individuals. Like, that's what he's he's basically trying to make an argument that, like, banning people from YouTube for what they say it should be valid, or just, I guess, even arresting them, maybe.
Well, I guess arresting them would be their purview of the government. But, I mean,
sure.
I think that, yeah, the way that it is interpreted now, YouTube does have the right to ban you for any reason.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, no one can deny YouTube's right to do that under the current fucking structure of things, but... That doesn't change that the concept of freedom of speech is about saying whatever you want and being able to do so without fucking at least legal repercussions.
Yeah.
Number two, it's not speech consequence. Respecting free speech doesn't mean that there can't be negative consequences for saying the wrong thing at the wrong time. If I'm making racist or misogynistic comments online and my boss finds out about it and fires my ass, that doesn't mean that my boss doesn't respect free speech. If someone else sees me making
doc dropping at this point, this seems like that's where he's going for. Like, oh, when you doc drop someone who says racist and homophobic things, it's okay if they fire your ass.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. I mean, who knows, dude? Like, once again, like, he's now adding his complications onto what is a very simple prospect.
Is this peach shit going anywhere, or what
yeah,
is the... What is
I don't know why he keeps showing peach shit.
What is the peach thing? Is he being paid by, like, the peach lobby or some shit? What's going on here?
He's getting paid by Monsanto.
Bigoted comments and calls me out on it. That doesn't mean that they don't respect free speech. Respecting disagreement is a crucial part of the concept of free speech, but respecting disagreement doesn't mean respecting every disagreeing opinion, no matter how ignorant or toxic that opinion. Bigots with poor judgment are not a protected class, and there is no...
Yes, they are.
Okay, you know what?
Oh, yeah. Yes, they are.
They extremely are.
But you know what he's saying furthermore, TJ? He's basically saying, I think this is kind of his way to defend, like, you know, the fact that he was trying to flag you off of YouTube as well. He's trying to say, okay, like, oh, this is actually justified.
Well, I don't know when this video came out or whatever, but...
Yeah, you don't get to arbitrarily decide what speech is bigoted and uninformed and then silence that speech. That's not freedom of speech. That's control of speech. So, yes, bigots that are uninformed are a protected class in this country. They're allowed to be bigoted, they're allowed to be uninformed, and they're allowed to say whatever the fuck they want.
Moral or legal principle requiring anyone else to put up with it. Number three.
Yeah, I mean, that's true.
Right. You don't have to sit around and listen to them.
Oh, yeah,
it
dude,
doesn't guarantee you a platform.
Yeah, you don't deserve a platform.
Respecting free speech also means respecting the rights of others to moderate their own spaces.
I swear to God, this peach shit better be going somewhere.
Dude. I'm free to say whatever I want, but someone else is also free to decide that they don't want me to say it in a venue they control. This can be especially true if what I have to say is not particularly original, informed, or relevant to the purpose the moderator means to serve with that platform.
Okay.
Free speech doesn't magically impart value to anything I might say. The value of what I have to say, beyond my own opinion...
The value of what you have to say is zero. Just pointing that out.
...opinion of it is determined by those who hear it.
Okay.
And on that subject, number four, it doesn't entitle you to be a bully. Sometimes...
If anyone's a bully, it's you.
More peach shit.
You're the one who goes around blocking everyone for every petty... I mean, like, your fucking argument is ridiculous because, like, people have literally, like, go through my Twitter. I've retweeted tons of people who have literally come to you and said things like, I respectfully disagree with your position on X, and you block them. Instantly. Instantly blocked. So...
You're not guaranteed a platform.
Yeah, I know they're not. I mean, like, but he's acting like, oh, well, you know, if you're not gonna do this in your discussion, or if you're gonna be a bully or whatever.
It's basically if you don't.
What he really means is anyone who disagrees with me is gone.
That's what I'm saying. If you don't have his exact same idea of freedom of speech, then you're basically just you're doing it wrong, and he's entitled to block you and shut you out.
The noble concept of free speech is invoked for the most petty reasons imaginable. I've seen people assert their freedom of speech after offending someone with an insult. I've seen people assert their freedom of speech after it became clear that what they were saying was obviously hurtful to the person they were saying it to. I've seen
people... Once again, that's part of freedom of speech.
Yeah,
your hurt feelings do not... Your feelings do not get placed before my right to hurt them. Otherwise,
well,
we
do.
Don't have free speech. We have feeling speech. See the difference, Steve? You don't have a right to not be offended. There's no right that you have to not be subjected to something that gives you offense. And it's stupid to expect that. And even have a discussion about free speech.
But does anyone believe that Steve honestly supports free speech? I mean, he clearly doesn't. I mean, he's making a bunch of arguments to kind of deflate freedom of speech. Like, he's trying to curtail what should be considered a free speech. Like, which to him, it's basically some bland, inoffensive dialogue, which you might disagree with him, but then he's pretty much just going to block you out after that anyways.
Already at this point in the video, free speech has been defined pretty much as speech I like.
Yep.
Yeah. And that's pretty much it. Like, if you agree with me and say things I like, then you're okay. But if you say anything else, then you're bad.
Shit.
Aw, yeah.
Restore honor to this family, TJ.
Do it! Yeah! Yeah, there it goes. Yep.
Oh, God, dude. That was a monster hit, too. Dude, that was a man-sized hit, dude.
Yep.
Oh,
did it come out your nose?
God.
That was great.
That was a volcano of a hit.
Oh, man.
I'm not even going to make fun of Scotty coughing after that hit, dude. TJ, you should be ashamed. You should be ashamed. I've never seen you take a hit that big, TJ.
Not only did he just destroy TJ with the smoking because TJ wouldn't even do it, Scotty beat TJ in a weightlifting contest. I was there.
No, you didn't.
Yeah.
I saw it.
Oh, shit.
TJ said we could have a rematch, dude, so...
...assert their freedom of speech to justify continuing to aggressively pursue a conversation with someone who clearly did not want to talk to them. Just as others can impose consequences for speech they find unacceptable or exercise discernment over who is allowed to speak on platforms they control, I can refrain from speaking out of respect for the circumstances or the sensitivities or concerns of others. Even if I really want to say
That's
something.
That's so foolish, dude.
Free speech and self-control are not mutually exclusive.
You can do that, but you're restraining yourself.
Number five, it doesn't obligate others to listen to you. There are those who believe that respecting free speech means being willing to grant a hearing to anyone and everyone who has something to say about anything.
Let's talk about who's listened to and who's not, because I've actually, over the last 30 days, I've gained more subscribers than you've ever had. And also, your subscriptions, ever since I made that video about you, are down. I think they went down like 1,000.
His views.
Several thousand.
Yeah. Have you seen his views?
No.
But furthermore,
Steve Shives' social blade. Let's not talk about...
But listen to what he said. But listen to what he said, TJ. He said, just in this video, let the people decide the value. So if he believes that... Then the value clearly is decided with it.
So here's the value they've decided.
So now he's all the way down to a D+ channel now. I mean,
He's an F. He's an F channel.
I mean, that's a significant drop. And then if you go down here, you'll see like the graph of his views. Look at his view decline.
It's going down.
Wow. This is astonishing.
It's free fall, dude.
I mean, he was getting like almost 500,000 views a month. I mean, that's not shabby, you know. And now look at it. It's like almost all the way back. Like it's below when he actually started, I guess. I don't know.
This looks like a graph of the American economy leading up to 1920.
Yeah.
Yeah, a lot of YouTubers subs that promoted him have rescinded their like commendation of him, like Dark Matter. That, I believe,
look at Friday.
Said,
holy
I can't
shit.
Support this guy.
Friday, I think, I don't know. I think Friday's when I posted the video. It's down 504, then 110, then 66, then another 104, then 51, then 54. So, I mean, he's just losing subs by the day.
His views
are in the fucking toilet. It looks like he's averaging, it says he's averaging negative views a day somehow. That doesn't make sense, but.
Yeah, and he has to pay money.
Most of his days, like 15,000, 8,000, 13,000, 17,000, 5,000, 4,000, you know.
Man, Steve, so if anything, the value has clearly been shown between you and TJ that we know where everyone's fucking stands.
I mean, pull mine up in comparison just so people have an idea.
Pull mine up so everyone has an idea.
Yeah, show them how awesome
Show them
how my channel does in comparison.
Oh, TJ, your channel's getting
massive. Well, no, I mean, it actually makes a fucking point because...
It does.
Because this guy's fucking sitting there saying, like, people decide for themselves what to listen to and all this shit. And,
you know, what they place value in, so let's see what they place value in.
That's the value they place in Steve Shives.
You know, I think it's kind of bullshit that they're ranking you as a B+ still with all the growth that you've had. I think you should be A- at least at this point.
Yeah, at least a fucking solid
B. The grade
B.
is kind of, I don't really trust it too well. Like some channels are like A+, and they're really not growing that much.
Yeah, whatever. But go down to fucking there. I mean, like, look. I mean, I've last 3 days, 5,000, 7,000, pretty much another 7,000 a day. Probably be more than 7,000 by the time the day wraps up. Fucking getting hundreds of thousands of views a day. How many does it say is my average right there? It says my average daily views is like 260 something. But in the last few days, it's been like 500,000 a day. And Steve Shives is honestly going to fucking sit there and make some vague video about freedom of speech where, I mean, I don't know if he's talking directly about me, but he certainly said that I don't deserve a platform and that he would get rid of me if he could, yet.
Oh, yeah.
Look at what the people have chosen.
It seemed like he was talking about you or people like you.
Look at what the fucking people have chosen. Look at this. There's way more of an audience for what I'm saying than there is for what Steve Shives is saying. Steve Shives fucking sucks. No one likes what he has to say. No one gives a fuck. Fuck Steve Shives.
The numbers ain't lying on that one.
And if you go to any of the channels, if you go to any of the channels that he hates, Sargon is killing him. Mm-hmm. Fucking
was it Undoomed?
Undoomed is killing him. All these fucking channels are killing his ass. Chris Raygun is killing him. Yeah, even fucking Mr. Repsion is fucking killing him.
I bet Repsion could beat Steve Shives in arm wrestling.
Probably.
And that says a lot.
I was looking, I don't remember where I saw it, but someone said, you know, Steve Shives has a really thin neck. And someone's like, yeah, he also has really thin skin.
Yeah, it's true.
Anyway, I guess that's pretty much a show.
That's the show.
Thank you, guys. Please come to our meetups in Toledo and New Orleans.
Please subscribe.
Subscribe to our channel. Thumbs up this
Very
video.
Very important.
We love you all.
Yes.
We'll be back for the private show.
We'll be back for the private show on Friday for all you patrons. That'll be at 4 o'clock.
Peace, guys.
Peace.
Good night.
Good night, everybody.
See you in New Orleans.
See you in New Orleans.